University Jaguars are two-time defending champions of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. They're back again with 11 wins this season and a swagger from last week's SWAC title game win. Pete Richardson's Jags are ready to claim another ring. The Hampton University Pirates have other plans for their first ever Heritage Bowl. Mission one is to avenge an October loss to Southern that knocked them from atop the Black College rankings. Hampton versus Southern, and all the festivities next.
Check it out now, now, now.
NBC Sports presents the 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Welcome to Atlanta and the Georgia Dome, site of the ninth McDonald's Heritage Bowl, featuring two of the best black college football teams in America. Today's game matches the Hampton Pirates from the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference against the powerhouse Southern University Jaguars, champions of the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Hello, everybody. I'm Ahmad Rashad. Hampton and Southern will kick it off in just a few minutes. This is a new experience for the Hampton Pirates, playing in their very first Heritage Bowl. Now, the Jaguars of the Southern University, on the other hand, are regular visitors here, playing in their sixth Heritage Bowl, and they've only lost one of them. Now, in addition to the football, we'll also bring you the Battle of the Bands at halftime. But right now, let's go to the guys who will call the game, Tom Hammond and James Lofton. Tom?
All right, Ahmad, thank you very much. And, you know, this game provides us with some contrast in both teams and in quarterbacks. Southern, as you said, is the veteran Heritage Bowl team, their sixth appearance, the last five in a row. But their quarterback, Terrence Levy, is the former backup, thrust in the under center because of injury. And today, James, he makes only his second career start.
Yeah, and for Pete Richardson, that must be a question mark. And can Terrence Levy have an encore performance like he did in last week's SWAC championship game? He has a lot of complimentary players on offense to help him out. And if he's the question mark, then the exclamation point for Southern has to be their dog day defense led by DeMarcus Miller. They went sack crazy in the first ball game against their opponents, and they hope to do the same thing today.
Well, as hot as Levy and the Southern offense has been, that team is still based on defense. Hampton, though, they like to think about offense. It's their first Heritage Bowl appearance, but they have the veteran quarterback. Roy Johnson has seen just about everything, nearly a four-year starter for the Pirates.
And for Joe Taylor, there's no question mark at the quarterback position, but I think the question mark must be, how can we protect Roy Johnson in this ballgame? Look at the numbers, two interceptions, seven sacks in the first ballgame. Now, Taylor looked at the offensive films from the whole season. He said, we need to get touches to the appropriate players, and these three guys are going to get 85% of the touches today. Zurrell Harris, Adrian Weidman, and Montrell Cooley. And if it works out the plan, then Coach Taylor may have a good offensive game plan today.
So Hampton does have a score to settle from that 21-6 loss to Southern in October. And as we listened in their locker room a few moments ago, it's obvious that they believe they can do it.
We can get it back, but you gotta believe. You gotta believe. You gotta believe. If you believe, we're gonna get it done today, man. I promise you that. I promise you. Champions on three. One, two, three.
And the Pirates obviously are ready. The McDonald's Heritage Bowl from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. Southern and Hampton. Kickoff coming up.
The time in your life.
Georgia Dome in Atlanta, the McDonald's Heritage Bowl, matching Hampton University from Hampton, Virginia, and Southern University from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. That's Justin Mattingly set to kick off, and Chris Parker deep for Hampton to receive the opening kick in the Heritage Bowl. Hampton winning the toss and choosing to receive to open the game. And the game underway is Mattingly's short kick taken by Parker at about the 12-yard line. Gets a blocker, too, and bursts free at the 40. Midfield, he has a blocker in front, finally taken down inside the Southern 40-yard line. Chris Parker, the sophomore from Smithfield, Virginia, with a 50-yard kickoff return.
I talked to Justin Mattingly, the kicker, before the ball game, and we were talking about NFL kickers, and he saw a guy miss three field goals in one ball game. He said the only worse thing than missing three field goals is having to make the tackle on kickoff.
So Hampton in great shape. The first play from scrimmage, they switch out of the I formation. Weidman, the tight end, switching sides. The tailback is Coley, their leading ground gainer on the season. Johnson, swing pass complete. Mike Jones. And Jones has about 11 yards and a first down for Hampton before Shannon Smith, the linebacker, chases him down. It is an 11-yard gain and a Pirate first down. There is that offensive line. Jason Thomas is headed to the Hula Bowl All-Star Game in Hawaii. Foreman and McClendon were all conference. Roy Johnson, the veteran quarterback, Coley leading ground gainer. Jones, Smith, Compton, and Weidman completing the offensive lineup. Johnson, after completing his first pass, under center. They're in the eye. Coley, the tailback. Coley's first carry. Got away from the initial hit. Takes it inside the 25 to the 24-yard line, where Dillon and Warner, the linebackers in the center of the Southern defense, make the stop. Bell, Miller, Mays, and Wilson up front. DeMarcus Miller had a big game in the earlier win over Hampton. He is a force at that left tackle spot. Channing Warner, a four-year starter, is the heart and soul of the defense at that middle linebacker spot. Second down play. Johnson, short drop. Slings the pass complete, and down inside the 20-yard line is Montrell Coley. Tackle by Smith and Pittman.
Watch that quick drop by Roy Johnson. I talked to Joe Taylor before the ball game. He said part of this offensive game plan is to get him off to a good start. You see the offensive leaders there, Cooley, Jones, Broughton, Zarrell, Smith. He said he doesn't want to get Johnson racked around a lot early in the ball game. He doesn't want a repeat of that 7-sack performance in October.
Joe Taylor and his opposite number, Pete Richardson, both have won black college national championships. Third down play for Johnson. Handoff is to Jones. And Jones has a first down inside the 10 down to the 6-yard line. Finally tracked down by Gillis Wilson. But fullback Mike Jones blasting for 12 yards. It'll be first and goal.
Well, the Oakland Raiders used to do it behind Art Shell and Gene Upshaw. And what Hampton likes to do, they love to run left behind Mitchell Foreman, Jason Thomas, left guard, left tackle, and also Kelly McClendon, the center. And when you take a big back like Mike Jones, you don't get very many defensive backs who want to step up in front and sacrifice their body to take him down.
Jones, the fullback in the eye, Coley, the tailback. First and goal from the 7, opening drive for Hampton. Johnson appears to be changing the play now. His coach, Joe Taylor, said he has a green light anytime. To Coley, the tailback, fights for a yard or so. Didn't quite make the 5-yard line. Gillis Wilson again leading the tackle with Channing Warner coming up to put the big hit on.
Okay, even though you're trying to change the play at the line of scrimmage, believe me, when wide receivers get out wide, for some reason they can't hear the quarterback if he wants to change to a run. They like him changing to pass.
Oh, yeah. As a former wide receiver, you're just saying you can't hear.
When they hear the run, they don't want to hear that.
Wide receivers to either side, and now Coley moves out of the tailback spot and lines up on the slot to the top of the screen. In motion, Compton. Johnson with a handoff. Jones takes it down to about the 2-yard line. Mike Jones lugging it tough inside yards. DeMarcus Miller making the tackle.
I talked to Joe Taylor. He said, when I get down in my goal line area, I bring in my jumbo backfield. Watch number 6, one of the biggest running backs I've ever seen in my life. He's listed at 6 feet, 260. Well, he's not 6 feet, and he weighs a lot more than 260.
That's Norman Clement, who is the fullback in the formation. Mike Jones is now a tailback. He's already carried twice for 16 yards, Jones. This is a Mayer, and Mayer bumping ahead right to the corner of the end zone. No signal yet. And he did not get in. Stopped just short of the goal line by Shannon Smith and Bradney Pittman. It was Kareema Mayer, the senior, 220 pounds from the tailback spot in that jumbo formation.
You'd think with the jumbo formation that you're going to run inside, but he tries to bounce it outside. If he just extends the ball a little more with that left hand, he might get it over the pylon and get the nod from the official. But he makes good ball security, doesn't get the ball in, and probably see him plug it right up the middle here.
It's fourth down now, fourth down and goal just shy of the goal line. A fourth down play for Hampton, and Johnson changes the play. Still that jumbo formation, fumble football. Football is loose. And Southern with a great defensive stand. Bradley Pittman recovering the fumble. It appeared that Kelly McClendon and Roy Johnson had trouble with the exchange. There is a penalty marker on the play.
You know,
One of the things that you really need to do, you need to be aware of the clock. It got down to 25-second clock, got down to 2 seconds. Johnson would have been a lot better off just calling a timeout there. Obviously, he didn't know he was going to fumble the ball. But be patient. Take well good advantage of your scoring opportunities.
Dead ball foul. Against the defense. Dead ball, personal foul. Against the offense. Decline. First down.
Referee Carl Pearson with the call. Obviously, the officials trying to take charge early. A great goal line stand by Southern.
The 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl is brought to you by McDonald's and its franchisees. Once again, proud to sponsor the 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl. By National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. By Speed Stick Deodorant, proud sponsor of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. And by Mach 3 from Gillette, the first triple blade razor for the closest shave and fewer strokes with less irritation.
The Atlanta skyline where Hampton took the opening kickoff, drove all the way down the field. They had it fourth and inches, bobbled the snap from center and don't score. And here's Southern, first offensive play. Ryan Lewis, the speedster at tailback, bursting free for a big run across the 15 to the 17-yard line where he's tackled by Travis Coleman and Curtis Blackwell. There's the Southern offensive line. Levy, the quarterback, he's done a superb job stepping in the third quarter against Grambling. Ryan Lewis, Calvin Mills, and that receiver, Michael Hayes, has had two brilliant games back-to-back. Terrence Levy changing the play now. Hampton showing blitz. Second and short. Draw play. And the handoff is to Ryan Lewis, who spins ahead close to a first down. Tackled again by Curtis Blackwell. Here's the Pirate defense. Scott Bland, Cornell, and Foot up front. The man to watch is in the middle of that defense. Deion Hunt led the Mideastern Athletic Conference in tackles, one AA All-American, and the MEAC Defensive Player of the Year. There he is, number 46. The senior from Detroit, Michigan. Close enough that they will measure. And as you can see, it is enough for the Southern first down.
There you're talking about Deion Hunt. And I don't know if defensive players are born angry, but Deion Hunt came in. We congratulated him on being Defensive Player of the Year and being All-American. First thing out of his mouth was, I should have made All-American last year, too.
He was a little more gracious than that, James, but he did make the point that he thought he had deserved it last year as well when he also was the leading tackler. Three times he's been the leading tackler for Hampton. Quarterback draw, Terrence Levy, dodging players, slides down just short of the 30-yard line. He got 8 or 9 yards on the quarterback draw. Terrence Levy, a redshirt sophomore from New Orleans who is making quite a name for himself.
Well, you spread everybody out. Levy does a nice job. He goes to the left. The reason he goes left is because Deion Hunt goes to his right. So quarterbacks are smarter than linebackers.
We spoke to Levy yesterday, and a quiet, unassuming young man. He said, I'll give the credit to the team. Don't give me any credit. You can't meet a more unassuming young man at the quarterback spot.
Go!
Nearly missed that handoff, but finally did get it to Ryan Lewis. And Lewis is finally tackled by Corey Kaysen as Southern picks up another first down.
Talked to Lewis before the ball game. He's been hobbled about the last month by an ankle injury. You see 1,100 yards rushing. They probably could have had a lot more, but he's been in and out of parts of ball games. He said the ankle feels good as long as the defensive players don't play dirty.
Second highest all time. He's also a sprinter on the Southern track team. Here he is again on a delayed handoff. And good running again, just short of the 40-yard line. Finally tracked down by Monty Foote.
Lewis's numbers. He was a guy who stayed close to the bench for the first couple years, but when Pete Richardson called on him, he responded with over 1,100 yards rushing this season.
And has carried four times for 20 yards so far today. From the shotgun, Levy rolling, being chased. Hunt had a shot at him, and he unloaded it short of his intended receiver, incomplete. Deion Hunt getting penetration from his linebacker spot. Joubert, the intended receiver, but the ball well short.
Everybody talks about it. Every defensive unit say we want to pressure the passer. I think it's even more important in this ball game because Levy
last week. He passed for 426 yards. So you look at that defensive unit, and they think to themselves, we can put pressure on this guy. Maybe we can rattle him a little bit.
Southern comes out to, in an empty backfield now. No running backs and five wide receivers, three of them to the top of the screen. Levy steps up. He's got good protection. Now it breaks down, and he lets it fly, and it is intercepted. Did he get it before, or did he trap it? Yes, intercepted.
Like
intercepted by Vincent Lewis. Levy had good protection. Looked for his third receiver, it would appear. Let the ball go, and it's picked off by Vincent Lewis. His second interception of the season. So another turnover. This one goes Hampton's way.
Hey, that safety has taught the mirror the quarterback, especially when that quarterback scrambles and moves in the pocket, and that's what Vincent Lee does. And Lewis happens to be open at the end of the play, too.
So Hampton takes over, and they go deep on the first play from scrimmage, and that's nearly intercepted as the ball hung up there. Johnson didn't quite have enough steam on it. Pittman nearly picked it off, intended for Zuriel Smith.
I think it's the humidity inside the building.
He
was a little late in pulling the trigger on this because he had his receiver open. Zuriel Smith had Pittman by a step and lots of field to work with. When you throw that pass pattern, you really want to throw the ball away from the defensive back, not so much up the field.
And Pittman should have had the interception. Just went right through his hands. As you see that he was the Southern leader in 97 and 98. Picked off three in the regular season this year. Second and 10. Short drop. Pass complete to Coley. To Smith. Hit immediately at the 40-yard line by Damon Hill.
You know, when we had that fourth and one play, you want to get points on the scoreboard. Do you kick a field goal here? Do you try and go for it? The center snap between Kelly McClendon and Roy Johnson, you think would be automatic. These guys have played together for 45 games in a row. You wouldn't think them fumbling a snap, but that time you saw Roy Johnson get under the center late. Bad exchange.
No score, just past the 7-minute mark in the first quarter. Third down play. Johnson has his man wide open. The catch made by Smith. Zuriel Smith for 12 yards and a Hampton first down. Knocked out of bounds by Damon Hill. Well, log on to MSNBCSports.com for special coverage of today's McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Some say Southern kicker Matt Bussart might have a future in the NFL. Check out his story. Plus, listen in to an in-depth interview with the legendary Eddie Robinson and take a Heritage Bowl trivia quiz all at MSNBCSports.com, the official website of NBC Sports. First down for Hampton, just into Southern territory. Coley, the tailback. Nice play made by Gillis Wilson, who fought off the blocker and wrapped up Coley. Forward progress stopped and whistle blows, but Wilson actually was blocked at the point of attack, fought off the blocker and made the tackle.
Boy, this is a good defense. What's their nickname? Dog Day Defense. And look where they ranked. I think that's first in a lot of categories. Points allowed, fumbles, interceptions, sacks, 48 sacks, and passing defense efficiency. Now, that's a new one for me. I'd have to get my computer out to tabulate that, and that's Michael Vitt. He calls all the signals and gets this stuff done for Pete Richardson.
Johnson to pass on second and 10, and overthrows Broughton, his intended receiver. But the last two games, that Dog Day defense has been just dog.
Dog Day. It really has. Giving up a lot of points, but you know what? DeMarcus Miller, their defensive standout, what he said? He said, we played when it counted. In the fourth quarter, we still won the ball games.
Two big wins in come-from-behind fashion against Grambling in the Bayou Classic and against Jackson State last weekend in the first ever SWAC championship game. Third down and long for Hampton. Rifles it, and it's knocked down, incomplete, good defense. Bradley Pittman right on the spot again to knock it away from Zuriel Smith.
Yeah, I think Bradley Pittman was on the spot just a little early. You don't see Joe Taylor protesting too much, but Zuriel Harris works down the field. He starts a comeback, and there's the contact early.
Mm-hmm.
When I say early, I mean there should have been a yellow
flag
behind.
Right. And Warner in front and Pittman behind, but no flag. And Tellus Bolden will punt to Alexander. Bolden was booming him in practice here yesterday, drawing oohs and ahs from his teammates. That'll draw an ah, but not an ooh.
That's going to work out well, though.
Yes, it is. Well, that's the way he planned it all the time. Ooh, ah, it rolls all the way to the 7-yard line. That's a 41-yard punt. We'll be back.
How about some punts?
Quarter of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl, Hampton and Southern. Southern takes over deep in its own territory. Levy from the shotgun, fires it out into the flat. Catch made and hit immediately. Joubert made the grab, and then Spike got him before he could get much of a gain out of it, a yard or two.
And when you throw that screen behind the line of scrimmage, what you're thinking? You're thinking we're going to get 6, 7, 8 yards at that time. Spike, a real nice tackle, because he had to fight off the block of Michael Hayes before that ball carrier got out there.
Pete Richardson's Jaguars facing a 2nd and 9 from their own 9-yard line. Levy, pass behind his intended receiver Hayes, and incomplete. It's going to be 3rd and 9 coming up for the Jaguars.
You would think that this is a pretty easy throw, just throw and catch, but when you take the snap from the gun, you don't really have time to drop back. You notice Levy didn't even have a chance to get his hands around the laces. He needs to just take that ball, mold it up, and then make the throw. Don't rush yourself. Right now, he's a little nervous.
Well, he admitted he was going to be nervous. He said last week, having time to think about it, he was real nervous. Grambling, he didn't have time to think. He came into the game, makes a key throw there to Hayes, but Hayes makes a cardinal mistake. He did not get enough territory for the first down. He'll be stopped a yard or two short by Spite again. So Levy on the money with a throw, but Hayes making a mistake, not getting enough yardage.
You know, you wonder about the wide receiver not gaining the distance for the first time. You're supposed to run your route at the proper depth, then come back for the football. And, you know, most offensive coordinators now think, you know, every receiver can break every tackle and get that first down for him. And they don't want to risk having the quarterback stand in his own end zone for that extra time.
Coleman awaits the kick by All-American Matt Bushart of Southern. Coleman retreats to the 38, tries to get to the outside, surrounded by blue-shirted Southern special teamers, and is knocked out of bounds after a 3-yard return of a 40-yard punt. We'll still scoreless at the Heritage Bowl.
How about some punts?
A regional vice president of McDonald's, and you've made a wonderful commitment to this game. What does that commitment entail?
Well, Ahmad, thank you. You know, this is our 4th year of being the title sponsor of the Heritage Bowl. And the thing that we're really happy with is the fact that our African-American, historically black colleges and universities are able to give so much to the communities as well as educate our African-American youth.
We thank you very much. A wonderful statement on that behalf.
Well, thank you very much, Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Bill. Back to you, Tom.
Thank you, Ahmad. Montrell Coley with a first down carry for Southern, hit by big Nathaniel Bell, number 99, the 270-pound senior from New Orleans. And the battle of field position has been won by Hampton so far. They average starting on their own 47, while Southern averages starting on their own 9. So far, no points on the board. Hampton had it 4th and goal, inches from the goal line, and fumbled, and we're nothing-nothing with 4 minutes and 12 seconds left in the first quarter. Southern showing blitz, but Warner does not come. Johnson sets up a screen, and the pass is complete to the tight end Weidman, who runs over would-be tacklers, punishing the defenders for Southern. And big Adrian Weidman, 265 pounds, 6'5", finally hauled down by Overton and Mays, 26-yard gain.
And I would have to think that that play makes Joe Taylor feel pretty good, because this play takes a long time to develop, and in the face of this screen, Roy Johnson sees the blitz. Very patient, gets the ball to Weidman. Weidman, not the nimblest of tight ends, but manages to skirt down that sideline, and that is a nice gain for a big guy.
Damian Hill knew he was there as Weidman knocked him out of bounds as he tried to make the tackle. First down for Hampton in Southern territory. Draw play. This is Coley. Coley got away from one tackler, still kept his balance, and then finally is marked down. And they're saying keep running. The whistle hasn't blown. Everyone thought the play was over, and they ruled his knee was not down. He could have kept running, and finally his teammates said, keep going, keep going. We could hear them. It'll be a big run by Montrell Coley, and that's about the strangest I've ever seen. 16 yards.
Well, I saw that spin move that he made, and he is so low to the ground. He's listed at 5'9", but he'd be lucky to be 5'9" with platforms on. And watch him as he goes.
Eyes
that
down
knee
right there.
Graces the ground, but you know what? They don't come in and blow the whistle right away.
And now everyone says, keep going, keep going. And he says, what? Well, his knee should have been marked down. Got a few more yards after he should have been ruled dead. First down for Hampton. They're at the 16 of the Jaguars. Play clock. And he did not get the play off. That'll be a 5-yard delay of game penalty against Hampton. Joe Taylor can't be happy with that. He's got his veteran quarterback who is saying, get the plays in early.
Dead ball, delay of game, against the offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, the culmination of the preceding play was so crazy that it threw Hampton's timing off. Everybody's waiting around. They didn't know if he was down, where the ball was going to be spotted. They're a little late getting it in, but the one thing that Johnson does is he really reads over the defense and tries to make a decision. Once he gets up to the line of scrimmage, we talked about the fact that Joe Taylor has given him complete carte blanche to call plays at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes the quarterback has to be more aware of the play clock.
Roy Johnson, a graduate student. He has a business management degree, working on a master's in education. He wings this one downfield over the head of his intended receiver, Zuriel Smith. Well, coming up Saturday, Christmas night, celebrate the holidays with a highly anticipated return of the NBA on NBC at 7 Eastern, a rematch of last year's Eastern Conference Finals, Allen Houston and the Knicks against Reggie Miller and the Pacers. Men in the nightcap, Tim Duncan, the world champion Spurs, visiting L.A. to take on Shaq and Kobe Bryant, the red-hot Lakers. An NBA holiday doubleheader in prime time, Christmas night, starting at 7 Eastern, only on NBC.
Hey, you know who's watching? Avery Johnson is a Southern grad.
Avery Johnson, right.
The game winner in NBA Finals last year?
He did, the point guard of the San Antonio Spurs. Draw play handoff, takes it inside the 15-yard line. Montrell Coley hit there by Edrice Brown and Sean Overton. Two good NBA games as the NBA returns to NBC on Christmas Day. Coley's numbers now, sorry, James, 6 carries, 26 yards.
How come they don't play basketball outdoors? I mean, a real sport.
Well, they do,
like
actually.
Football you play outside.
Yeah, have you looked up lately? You see this roof over your head?
Oh, is that what that is? That was just a cloudy day.
3rd and 8 for Hampton from the 14 of Southern. Johnson. Trapped and sacked. Edrice Brown, the strong safety, the all-SWAC performer who packs a lot of power in that 5'9", 170-pound frame, gets the sack of Roy Johnson.
And the tough thing about this sack is he has time. He had a man open. He had Coley open, but he was trying to look and wait for Zurrell Smith to come free, but he didn't. And the bad thing about this sack is it puts him at the outer edge of A.C. Wyatt's range. I talked to him for the ball game, he said 45 yards, the coaches are comfortable. I think I can kick it from 50, but this is a long field goal attempt for A.C. Wyatt.
43 yards for Wyatt. Sent it on its way, and it is no good. So the sack, a 12-yard loss, was huge. Once again, the Southern defense is up to the task. Hampton and Southern are scoreless. Ahmad Rashad at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. McDonald's Heritage Bowl. We start the second quarter. Hampton and Southern are scoreless. Hampton has moved the ball but has nothing to show for it. In fact, 35 plays run in that first quarter. 27 of them were in Southern territory. And Hampton has not been able to score. Johnson on a rollout, tiptoeing down the sideline and finally marked out of bounds at midfield and close to a first down. It should be a first down, as a matter of fact. There are the first quarter stats. Big passing yardage advantage for Hampton. 3 turnovers, 2 of them by Southern, the 2 interceptions by Vincent Lewis.
And really a huge advantage in time of possession. And when you talk to Pete Richardson, one of the things that he talks about is controlling the tempo of the ball game. You see his arms folded. You know, I've taken a couple of classes here and there. That's not a happy position when you get your arms folded like that.
Not a happy position for your players either. You kind of want to give him a little space when he's showing that body language, the former NFL defensive back. Johnson fires too hard and behind the intended receiver, Zuriel Smith. And the two teams played in Indianapolis in October. Hampton had the better stats also, but lost the game 21-6. Why did they lose?
Yeah, but you have to look right here. Sacks, seven sacks in that ball game, three turnovers, and you had one of those sacks, that turnover, that led directly to a touchdown for the Southern defense.
Johnson has hit 5 of 10 passes, 54 yards, facing a 2nd and 10 here. He's under center, drops back. Protection is good, and he's on target. Pass complete to Smith, and Smith fights his way to the 30-yard line of Southern before he's tackled by Sean Overton. It's a 20-yard hookup from Johnson to Smith. Smith, the freshman receiver from Mechanicsville, who tied for top honors with 31 catches in the regular season.
And I talked to Donald Hill, the offensive coordinator, before the ball game. The one thing he said, we got a lot of freshmen, redshirt freshmen, playing at wide receiver, and these guys have to get past just having feel good about making a catch. They want to get them to a position where they're naturally running with the ball after the catch.
There's one of those players you said needed the touches for Hampton to win today. First down for the Pirates. Tough running after an initial couple of yards. Channing Warner leading the defense against Mayer. And a short gain on the play of a couple of yards.
When you talk about tough running in that first ball game in October, Hampton only averaged 2 yards a carry. Now, granted, that takes into account quarterback sacks, but the line of scrimmage was controlled by both defensive units, and DeMarcus Miller, we talked to him, he said the team who is more physical up front will win this ball game, but really right now the battlefield position is being won by Hampton. They just have to cash in and get on the scoreboard.
Split backs, two wide receivers on second down. Johnson, swing pass, complete. Pass caught by Mayer, and Mayer will come up about 3 yards short to the first down, hit by Darnell Henderson. Coming up tonight on NBC.
He's the perfect holiday guest, and he's coming to NBC tonight. Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls, starring Jim Carrey.
Do I have something in my teeth?
NBC tonight.
Outrageous. Now, coming up tonight on NBC.
Is that real asparagus or fake asparagus?
I don't want to know. Johnson 7 of 12. Here's his 13th attempt. Looked one way to try to look off the defense. Came back the other way for Broughton, and the pass too high and maybe too hard. Does he need a little more touch on that throw or not?
Well, he felt a little pressure because the guys are coming at him, but when you're going to throw the ball late, you want to put a little extra on it. You see him look right, then he comes back left, and he knows that these are only 6-yard routes. These guys are going up there 6 yards and stopping. The last thing he wants to do is throw a soft little pass out there and then have Pittman and the defensive back catch it and start going in the other direction.
There's Roy Johnson. I don't know that we've ever talked to a more poised or pleasant young man in all our college football activities than Roy Johnson. A very keen student of history, wants to teach history and coach, perhaps. He drills that one right between two defenders, and it's complete down to the 15-yard line. The catch made by Smith in traffic. He was sandwiched by Shannon Smith, who hit him the hardest. And we were talking about, there's Smith who made the catch. Talking about Johnson, he wants to coach and perhaps teach history, and is a keen student of Martin Luther King. He is from the Atlanta area. Has been to King's house, has read up on him, and he said the civil rights movement is his main area of interest in history. He said he likes to look at the old films and to see the fear but not feel the fear of what it was like during the civil rights movement. Travis Hales gets the handoff and plows ahead for a couple of yards before Robert Chapman and Gillis Wilson put him to the turf.
You know, we are not the only guys talking about Johnson. I think the NFL is also interested in the guy. When that pre-draft thing came out, they listed him as the 10th best quarterback coming out of college football this year. You look at his numbers, not spectacular, not gaudy, but see him on the run there. That's one of the things that the NFL looks at. They look at that mobility, that pocket awareness. And when they sit down and they talk to this guy, you come out of the room and you go, wow, he has something between the ears.
It's his 5th year at Hampton. He took over during his redshirt freshman year and has been at the controls ever since. There's a drop by Smith. Smith had that one right in his hands, and once again, Hampton starting to sputter a little bit down here in the red zone.
Well, I think that Smith is thinking, if I catch this ball, I spin to the outside, I can get in the end zone, because he feels that defensive back inside him. But the thing you have to do first, make the catch, take the initial gain and then get something after the catch. That's why it's called run after the catch, not run before the catch.
And a timeout has been taken by Southern. We're in the second quarter. Hampton and Southern still scoreless, but Hampton knocking on the door.
Brought to you by Pele Pele, the original urban brand of choice since 1978. By Tampax, Tampax was there. By the United States Marine Corps, the change is forever. And by Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Tom Hammond, James Lofton, Ahmad Rashad, the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. 11:45 left till halftime. Hampton and Southern are scoreless. Hampton facing a third and six from the Southern 11-yard line. High formation, Coley the tailback. Pitch to him. Coley wants to throw, and he's got a man wide open for the touchdown. It's Weidman, the tight end. Montrell Coley on the halfback option pass, throwing it to the tight end Weidman for the score.
I'm watching the play. I'm watching the defense lineup. I'm saying they're going to come after the quarterback. They're coming after Johnson. You can see them in a blitz situation. And then I watch the toss, and I say, that's not going to work. It's not going to work at all. But he does a nice job. He takes the pitch, and then he molds it under his arm. And you saw number 33, Darnell Henderson, coming back into the pitcher. He was the cornerback who bit up on that side. Joe Taylor said, that's really our only trick play, that halfback pass.
And he sold the run just long enough for the linebackers to be a little hesitant. The point after is good by A.C. Wyatt. And the Hampton Pirates take the lead in the Heritage Bowl. They're up 7-0 on Southern. Hampton Band all fired up after the Pirates take a 7-0 lead over Southern in the Heritage Bowl. Weidman, number 88, capping that scoring drive on the halfback pass. Gary Bowie with the kickoff. Right down the sideline, it'll be marked out of bounds about the 32-yard line where the Jaguars will take over. Up next on NBC, 1994 Olympic gold medalist Tommy Moe leads the Americans as they take to the mountain to compete in the Ford Downhill Series, one of skiing's most competitive professional downhill ski tours. That's the Ford Downhill Series coming up next here on NBC.
You talk about fear. try going downhill and not being able to stop very well.
Look at the time of possession in favor of the Pirates. Total yards as well. They finally got a score to show for all their movement of the football. Levy from the gun. That pass deflected and incomplete. Deflected by Corey Kaysen, the linebacker.
And a nice job by Corey Kaysen. He's supposed to be in this passing lane, but they try the play-action fake. He hesitates for a second. He keeps his eyes on the quarterback, and he gets that big left hand up there. He elevates, because if not, Michael Hayes is running down the street by himself, well, down the field by himself.
Pitch the ball to Ryan Lewis. It's about 3 yards to the 35, where he's hit by Harry Cornell. Lewis, six carries, 18 yards so far.
And we talked about the guys getting the 85% of the touches for Hampton. Well, for Southern, it really is Lewis and Hayes, and that's where the offense starts. If those two guys can't get involved and get a little more active, they're going to continue to stagnate.
2 of 9 for Levy. Tough afternoon so far. Empty backfield here with 5 receivers in the formation. Levy's pass too hard for Hayes, who was running the slant. That's his favorite route. He had an inside step on Spate, but the pass too hard.
That you wouldn't think that a guy 6'5", that you'd be able to throw the ball over his head, because Hayes played basketball in college, and when he came out at high school, you know, he said Southern was one of the teams that wanted me to play basketball for him, but even he can't get up for that one.
Hayes, as you said, recruited by Southern for basketball, recruited by virtually all the major universities, 1A schools for football, went to LSU and then left this season and came to Southern. Bussard once again gets a good roll on the punt. It'll be marked out of bounds at the 18-yard line. It goes in as a 47-yard punt with no return. Hampton still has the lead.
haven't earned enough miles for a free vacation? With the Delta United Frequent Flyer Partnership, you can apply miles flown on either airline to either account. Since together, Delta and United serve more U.S. destinations than any other partnership, you'll be earning trips faster. Delta Airlines, helping you earn trips faster.
Introducing Colgate Total Fresh Stripe Toothpaste. A fresh minty gel that keeps working long after you've finished brushing. Fighting bad breath while you're out and about. Fighting cavities and tartar when you're center stage. It even fights plaque and gingivitis. For protection all day or all night. Colgate Total Fresh Stripe Toothpaste. The brushing that works between brushings.
She has it.
What?
The new 2000 Ford Focus can handle anything you can dream up.
Christmas night, the NBA on NBC returns with a big doubleheader. First, the Knicks meet the Pacers in their first rematch of last season's conference finals. Then, the defending NBA champion Spurs face the hot new-look LA Lakers. The NBA on NBC, Christmas night at 7 Eastern.
Hampton University leading Southern 7-0 in the Heritage Bowl with 10:40 left in the second quarter. Hampton takes over at its own 18-yard line. Weidman in motion. Into Coley. Sort of tiptoeing toward the line of scrimmage. Ball was loose, but he was already down. Antonio Mays made the stop. There's Coley, who threw the touchdown pass. Former North Carolina Player of the Year three times at Goldsboro High School.
Three times.
And at one time had a nearly 3,500 rushing season in high school.
Well, he averaged 276 yards a game in high school. I can't imagine. You got 11 guys. You're playing against eight that you could rush for that many.
All the big name schools wanted him. Tennessee was right there to the last minute, but he was a late qualifier. Wound up in Hampton, and he said he never regrets a thing. He's had a great career with another year left. Flag down as Johnson scrambles and is bumped out of bounds right at the yard marker by Ed Reese Brown.
You know, the funny thing, when you watch the offensive line block the defensive lineman, it's kind of a big dance. And then you see somebody go down like they slipped on a wet spot on the floor, you know it's holding because it's just a complete takedown.
Holding against the offense, 10-yard penalty, repeat the down.
So the step off against Hampton for the hold.
And you're going to see exactly what I'm talking about. Here the dance starts and say, okay, want to dance? Now let's go get some punch. And they just take them down right there.
DeMarcus Miller, boo-boo, as from the Yogi Bear, has that low leverage, and sometimes that's all you can do is kind of just get down there with him.
And Pete Richardson says if you want to block him, you better put two guys on. That time they had one guy on him. And Kelly McClendon is a center. He needs to come over and help out, but McClendon's at a disadvantage. Boo-boo's 5'9", 5'10", and he's 6'5". He can't squat down low enough to get his hands under his pads.
Second and 19, draw play. Coley fighting his way upfield, did a good job of running across the 20 to the 22-yard line. That's a 14-yard gain. Didn't look like there would be much there, and Coley made it into something. Pittman and Matthews combining on the stop.
Yeah, but when you talk about good running backs, guys who keep their eyes up. I mean, here he's in traffic, getting pulled around the shoulder pad, but his eyes are always facing forward. He's looking for a place to run, and, you know, I don't like to see wide receivers watching their running backs get blocked, because that means that you're not blocking your guy. And that time, Zarrell Smith watched Pittman take down his running back.
Johnson, dangerous pass. Knocked down in incomplete. Nathaniel Bell had dead aim on it all the way. He was going to ramble in the end zone if the pass had been just a little bit lower. As it was, he batted it to the turf.
Look, see, in practice, when we ran that play, Nathaniel Bell, the defensive lineman, never dropped off. That time, Nathaniel Bell drops off in coverage. You hear about the zone blitz. That's exactly what this is. It's a zone rush. What that defensive end does, he drops back into coverage. Does a nice job getting that big paw up on the pass.
And he's 6'6 to start with. So a punting situation now. Ellis Bolden. Let's it fly. And Marcus Alexander will let it bounce. Bodies flying everywhere, and again, and that is going to be close to getting a flag. Still a legal hit, I suppose, because the whistle hadn't blown. And no flag is down. 40-yard punt with a roll, and Hampton's up 7.
He wasn't a real vocal guy, but you can see he's a leader. Saw that late hit on the punt. He's chewing out the guys, telling them that they have to play with their head, not just with emotion when this ball game is going on.
Here's a dropped ball by Hayes.
I think the debate is it a backward
right.
pass?
Is it a lateral or is it a forward pass? Ingrams came up with the ball.
But you know, you like your quarterback, Johnson, to be able to take control of the entire team, not just the offense, but the special team and the defense, because somebody other than the head coach has to be the guy to say, okay, we got to get this done. We got to play smart. We have to do what's necessary in this ball game, and don't let them get back in it.
Roy Johnson was in a heated discussion with Richard Rogers, one of the Hampton defensive backs. 2nd and 10 for Southern. Levy's pass complete to Hayes, who went upstairs to get that one, but the gain only 4 or 5 yards. And Hayes, as we mentioned, the transfer from LSU. He was recruited by all the big major universities, but he wanted to stay fairly close to his home in Opelousas, Louisiana. So he went to LSU. At that time, the Tigers were riding high, but the bottom sort of fell out the last couple of years for LSU. He wasn't getting along well with the coaches, and he was thinking about transferring. His mom read some things in the paper that Jerry DiNardo, then the LSU coach, had to say about her son. And when Michael called up and said, I'm thinking about leaving, she said, I agree, go for it. And here's a pass, Levy's 3rd interception, and a 3rd one picked off by Vincent Lewis. Lewis knocked out of bounds inside the 20, a flag is down. Vincent Lewis with his 3rd interception of the first half.
See, Levy, he's looking left, he's looking left, he's looking left for as long as I can imagine. His receiver just stumbles just a little bit when he comes out of the cut, Troy Ingram, and the ball goes right into the hands of Lewis. Sure, when Lewis went to bed last night, he said his prayers, he said, boy, I hope I can pick off one pass. I think 3 is far beyond the imagination for him. You see the ball coming right at him.
Ball was intercepted on the return, had a legal block in the back by the white team, 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
I think he meant an illegal block in the back.
Well, Levy and Lewis have been the most potent passing combination of the game. An early Christmas for Vincent Lewis, as Levy 3 times has pitched the ball in his direction. 3 interceptions all by Lewis. More yards on that return, 43, than Levy has passing. So Hampton takes over after the turnover again in good field position, the 27 of Southern. On the sweep, and the reverse. Reverse to Smith. Smith with blockers in front, convoy of blockers. Cuts back inside, dances his way to the 14-yard line. A 13-yard gain, Pittman finally brought him down.
They didn't get all that they wanted out of this, but they still got a lot. But the one thing about it, he's forced deep. See how deep he is? He must be 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage there. Now, the quarterback's out in front of the block. And when the quarterback's out in front of you, going, is he going to really get it done? I know he's a good athlete, but is he committed to blocking? And talked about the guys who need to get the touches. And it's been Coley, it's been Zurrell Smith, and also Weidman, the tight end.
First down play, straight ahead, Coley to the 9-yard line. Offensive line starting to open up some big holes on that play. Shannon Smith, the linebacker, made the touchdown saving tackle.
I talked to Joe Taylor before the ball game. I said, okay, you're going to get these guys the ball 85% of the time. But when you get down in that red zone, is this a chance to match up Weidman? We saw him on the halfback pass against a guy like Ed Reese Brown. Ed Reese Brown had three interceptions last week, but he's 5'9". Weidman is 6'5". It would seem like that's where you want to go with the football.
Second and five. Short drop. Laying it up for grabs. And it's incomplete. Dangerous pass. Zuriel Smith had the defense right with him. Pittman all the way. And that one was up for grabs. Could have gone either way.
Now you would think that a guy like Zuriel Smith, who is a long jumper and a high jumper, a good member of their track team, he can get up for this ball, but this ball almost hangs up a little too long because you see the defensive back has a chance to turn and locate the ball. You don't want that defensive back to have that much time to find the football as it's coming down. He actually has better position, yeah. Pittman does, than Smith.
Right. So now it's third down. Rolling. Coley with a block. Pass is complete down to the 1 yard line to Mayer. And it will be marked just short of the one. First and goal for Hampton. Edrice Brown saved the touchdown. But it'll be first and goal again for the Hampton Pirates.
The one thing you want when your quarterback rolls out of the pocket is you want patience and poise. And you see both here. He's not in a hurry to throw this football. He lets the play develop. Does a nice job in throwing a very catchable pass. You know, we talked about this guy playing at the next level, playing in the pros. I see a lot of elements that pro scouts would like.
First and goal. Mayer now is the tailback in the jumbo formation. Hand off to him. Looked like he was in, but no signal from the officials. Now they'll mark him down short of the goal line. Mayer comes in that jumbo formation with Clement. Couldn't quite pound it across.
Tom, I'm watching the play. The back shifted. The wide receiver is going in motion. You have people moving simultaneously, and the officials kind of just miss it. I mean, it looked so obvious. You saw the backs reset into the eye. The wide receiver's coming in motion, and no flags.
They did make a good call on no score because he did bounce into the end zone. Here he is again, Mayer. Hauled back with the Southern defense. Still no score. Twice they've sent Mayer, the 220-pound tailback, into the line. Twice he's been thrown back by the Southern defense. That time, Antonio Mays led the charge.
And you know what? If I'm Joe Taylor, I do it two more times. But this time, I run to my left. I mean, I have Mitchell Foreman. He's all MEAC. I have Jason Thomas. He's going to Hawaii. And then I have Kelly McClendon, my center. I put Weidman on that left side. I run that ball directly at the left side. I don't test DeMarcus Miller again. I know what he can do, and I know that he's a little better football player than Larry Vaughn, my right guard.
Reese Johnson made the first hit last time on the last play, too, up front for Southern. Here we are again, doing just what you say. Hit in the backfield and dropped at the 5 yard line. The play made by Rashawn Matthews.
And you run left, but you don't run wide left. If you're going to run wide, you leave Coley in the ballgame. When you bring in that jumbo backfield, you attack straight on. And if anything, I line up in the eye and I give it quick to number six. But watch it. They try and stretch this play. And when they stretch it, you get pressure from the inside.
Sean Matthews, the senior from Baton Rouge, another transfer from LSU, making the hit in the backfield, and then Warner putting him down for good. So Wyatt will attempt the field goal. It'll be a 21-yard attempt. It's up, and it is good. So the Hampton Pirates don't get the touchdown, but they pad their lead. It's now 10-0 Hampton.
Mom said
this year. Welcome back to the Heritage Bowl, where Hampton leads Southern 10-0, 3:54 left in the second quarter. Hampton getting the field goal after the interception. That drive covered 3 minutes and 59 seconds. Southern's last four drives combined, only 3:42. It's been three and out quickly for the Southern Jaguars. Hampton perhaps a little disappointed they were able to get only the field goal after that interception and great field position. They had it first and goal at the one. Couldn't score the touchdown. Kickoff taken at the 5 yard line. Bowie thrown back after he reaches the 22 yard line. A 17 yard return.
I don't think you should be displeased with a 10-0 score, but to get three interceptions in the first half to really shut down the other team. Now, granted, Southern's been playing every week. They've had a very long season. They're sitting here at 11-1. And Hampton had some time off after the season was over. And you wondered, would they come into the ballgame rusty? This is an event that Southern plays in, it seems like, every year, so they're used to the format.
Draw play. And the handoff to Ryan Lewis. Gets to the 25-yard line, about a four-yard gain. Blackwell and Lewis on the tackle. Well, Southern has just gotten nothing done those last four possessions.
I would say this next one will be under a minute and it'll be a punt.
If form holds. Levy with a pitch to Ryan Lewis. Trying to bounce outside and a stop for a loss. Curtis Blackwell, the senior from Oak Park, Maryland, got great penetration into the backfield and stopped Lewis before that sweep could develop.
You know, as great as Levy has been, here's Troy Williams, who was the starting quarterback all year long. And it was funny when we talked to Troy Williams before the Bayou Classic. He said, you know I haven't had a great season, and talking about a team that was sitting there at 9-1 at the time. So if he hadn't had a great season, then what was the prospect for the guy who was really playing behind him? He talked about the Cinderella ball game and Cinderella second half that he had in the Bayou Classic, but he's not gotten the job done so far today.
That's Levy, and he's lucky he's not intercepted for the fourth time. Spate had a chance at that one as Levy rolled and delivered for Joubert.
Talked about Levy in the pocket here. You see an immediate, it's a dash. The one thing you might want to do here, pull up so that you can throw a more accurate pass, but he's lucky that that pass is not more accurate, because if it's really on the money, then it's going to get intercepted. And you know what? You throw a bad pass and they knock you down.
Greg Scott knocked him to the
life
turf.
Life is just not fair.
You were right. Three quick plays and Bussard on to punt. Coleman awaits the boot. Bussard with a high kick. Coleman says get away from it. It'll bound out of bounds at the 40-yard line of the Hampton Pirates. A 39-yard punt. We've got a timeout at the Georgia Dome. It's been all Hampton so far. Have been a second half team as Hampton takes over at their own 41-yard line, leading 10-0, and a first down with 2.5 minutes left until intermission. Johnson with the pitch, gets to Hales, and he is short of the 45-yard line. You know, Hampton finished third in their conference, the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, as Florida A&M and North Carolina A&T elected to go to the 1AA playoffs. And when they were chosen for the Heritage Bowl, Pete Richardson of Southern was not that pleased. In fact, he said, he meant to say anyway, that they were third, but it came out, as reported in the media, as third rate. And of course, Joe Taylor jumped on that. They had 100 sheets printed up to hand to the players saying that he called Hampton third rate, and they've used that as motivation coming into this game. Johnson heaves downfield, intended for Zuriel Smith, with Pittman right with him and incomplete.
Interesting thing when we talked to Roy Johnson yesterday, he said, even though we were third place this year, you know, we've been champions. They were a championship ball club last year, and we want to show people that we're champions. So, you know, that was just a little more fuel to stoke the fire.
These two coaches, Joe Taylor and Pete Richardson, go back a long ways from Winston-Salem State, when Richardson was coaching there and Joe Taylor was at Virginia Union, and they're good friends with mutual respect. So there's no animosity involved. It's just a little gamesmanship, a little motivation ploy. There's tremendous respect between the two, as we spoke with both of them yesterday. Johnson under pressure, steps up in the pocket, now scrambles free, caught from behind and dropped about a yard short of the first down by Gillis Wilson, the all SWAC performer, the senior from Patterson, Louisiana.
Yeah, nice job by Southern, really turning up the heat up front. See, DeMarcus Miller just off the ball so quickly and into two guys. So when you do that, when you block double team on that one guy, that center can't get off and help from the outside.
So on fourth down, Hampton will punt, and the Southern's going to get one more chance to try to get some kind of offense going before halftime. Southern has called a timeout, as Bolden will punt when we return to action, with 1:26 showing on the clock. And of course, the big halftime performance coming up by both of these excellent bands. Ahmad will be on hand to take you through those halftime activities. And coming up at halftime, your first opportunity to participate in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl National Sweepstakes. Send each team's halftime or final scores on a 3x5 card to the address on your screen by January 6th. You could win prizes, including a vacation for four at the Renaissance Jamaica Grand Resort in Ocho Rios, a Gateway multimedia computer, or a JVC home entertainment system. Rules and entry forms are in December issues of Ebony, Essence, and BET Weekend.
I'll take the vacation to Ocho Rios. Yeah, I'll take that one.
I'm ready to go.
And, you know, the great thing about you, you're thinking, that sounds too easy, but just write down the scores from halftime or the end of the ball game. You can enter the contest. You don't have to guess the scores. That's great.
Bolden's in punt formation. And a snap over Bolden's head. He retrieves it. Nye's going to try to run with it. Finally, he's tackled at the 30-yard line. The ball free. And a scramble for the football. It'll be Southern's football at about the 35-yard line, the 36-yard line perhaps, as Gillis Wilson, the man that recovered the ball, knocked it loose after Bolden had recovered it. Here is
a low snap from Brian Holt. Just goes right through his legs. You know, if you get down on one knee as a punter or when you're holding for field goals, you can actually get up and then punt the ball after that. He does a nice job in getting away from a couple of guys, but he has to realize, I'm just a punter. I'll go to the weight room a whole lot. When big guys get around me, I better get down.
Wilson pulled him down and the ball came free. Here's a Levy quarterback draw play. He stumbles ahead for 4 yards. Deion Hunt covered him there as we come to the 1 minute mark till halftime. Familiar situation, the no huddle, of course. Southern runs that no huddle offense all the time. Empty backfield. Plenty of time for Levy across the middle. Has his man at the 15-yard line. Kentrell played with the reception. It covers 18 yards. Travis Coleman hit him. Southern threatening here in the final seconds before halftime.
And Hampton's going to have to make an adjustment. When they move down here inside the red zone, you kind of ignore that prevent look that you think of at the end of a half. Get up, play man-to-man, make a stop.
Jags have one timeout left. The clock did stop on the first down and then restarts. Levy's going to try to run again. Tackled at the 15-yard line. He gained a couple of yards, but more importantly, the clock continues to roll. Deion Hunt made the tackle, and now Southern has to use its final timeout. You need an incomplete pass to stop the clock. If you scramble, it's got to be a good one. And they'll have to use the last timeout. 21 seconds left.
I think at this point that Pete Richardson has to think, okay, we got 21 seconds. We really have two shots to throw the ball at the end zone. We can do that on second down and third down, but we don't want to complete a pass in the field of play and have the clock tick out on us. They can get a first down without getting a touchdown, but you don't want to get short of that first down marker and really have time bleed off the clock on you.
Tomorrow night on NBC.
NBC is the only place you can see It's a Wonderful Life this year.
Merry Christmas!
It's a Wonderful Life, Sunday at 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Now, they're showing that tomorrow night. I'd watch that every day from now until the new year. Right? It's just a great classic.
It never grows old on any time you see it.
I'm glad they haven't colorized it yet.
Right. It wouldn't be the holiday season without that classic. I'm
sure there are a lot of kids will be trying to fix the TV, wondering why it's in black and white, though.
Second down play, 21 seconds as the clock starts. Levy for the end zone and out of the end zone, incomplete. Now 15 ticks remaining. Hayes closest to it, but there wasn't a chance for anybody. That one by Levy way out of the end zone.
And purposely thrown over his head because there were one, two, three, four, count them, four defenders from Hampton right around Hayes.
And Levy now has hit only 4 of 15 through the air, 28 yards and 3 interceptions. Justin Mattingly is on to attempt the field goal. He's hit 15 of 20 on the season. This is a 33-yarder. sends it on its way, and it is true. So Mattingly finally gets Southern on the scoreboard as the Jaguars take advantage of the bad snap in punt formation by Hampton, convert the turnover into a field goal, and narrow the lead to 7. It's Hampton 10 and Southern 3 with 11 seconds left in the second quarter. Turnovers have been so important in this game today. 3 interceptions by Hampton of Southern passes, and a couple of fumbles by the Pirates. Well, here's some famous Southern former stars. Willie Davenport, 5-time U.S. Olympian at the 68 Olympics, won the gold medal in the 110-meter hurdles. Lou Brock, baseball's second all-time leading base stealer, inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1981. And of course, the most recent former Southern star, Avery Johnson, who once led the nation in assists while playing at Southern, the starting point guard for the NBA champion San Antonio Spurs.
And I think that was sweet for Avery Johnson, because there were a couple of other point guards from around the league who made the statement that San Antonio can't win with this guy playing point guard.
Damon Stoudemire being one of them.
I didn't want to point him out.
And he showed him, didn't he? Avery Johnson,
yes,
absolutely one of my favorite people in the NBA. It's a joy to talk to Avery. Here's the Southern kickoff. Fielded at about the 2-yard line. As Parker takes it to the 27. Out of bounds with 1 second showing on the clock, 26-yard return. So one tick left, as Hampton had all the momentum before Southern was able to take advantage of the turnover and get a field goal. And perhaps the momentum has shifted a little bit with that one series of plays. Let's see if second half, as we said, has been Southern's half throughout most of this regular season. Expect Hampton to just take a knee here to get the first half over with. And then you'll want to stay tuned for both bands coming up at halftime. And that'll end the first half of play. So stay tuned now for the exciting halftime show. The Hampton and Southern bands take to the field. Maud Rashad will be back with you after these messages.
Halftime show is brought to you by Greyhound Lines. Greyhound, the official ground transportation company of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Here now is the Hampton University marching force.
Smash it as we feature the Ebony Fire with Texas Red Martin of Atlanta and Erica Bell.
Oh, how I love these bands. As the Hampton University Marching Force plays on, we'll take a break. We'll bring you the Southern University Marching Band and an update on last night's action in the NBA right after these messages from your local station.
On the field right now, one of the finest bands in all the land, the Southern University Marching Band from Jaguarland.
The band will now take you through a precision drill under the sounds of Michael Jackson, entitled, Can You Feel It? Ladies and gentlemen, known as the rock, the high step, the moving and the grooving, the Southern University Marching Band is often imitated, but never duplicated.
Band performance was brought to you by Greyhound Lines. Go Greyhound and leave the driving to us.
So Southern is lucky to be in this game, only seven down, considering the way they played that first half.
Well, we see Pete Richardson on the sideline with that calm exterior. I'm pretty sure he erupted in the locker room at halftime because his ball team just was sleepwalking right in the first half.
Got nothing done offensively, and as we said, lucky to have surrendered only 10 points after three interceptions, three turnovers in that first half. Here are the first half stats, and you see once again Hampton dominating. Now remember, the first meeting in October, Hampton also had the edge in the stats, though they lost the game 21-6. But look at the time of possession, especially 21 minutes to just over eight, or nearly nine, for Southern.
And, you know, we talked about the quarterbacks at the outset of this ballgame, and you would think that Roy Johnson would be the guy who's had the hot hand, and he really did. But the key here is only sacked once. Remember in the first ballgame, mm-hmm. he was dropped seven times. So his offensive line has done a better job at protecting him, but they have missed vital chances to really up the score and to really put Southern behind the eight ball.
And Terrence Levy with those three interceptions, which could have been disastrous. Hampton had so many chances in the red zone and somewhat sputtered. They did get 10 points, but if you remember the opening drive of the game, they went only inches away from the goal line, fumbled a fourth and goal snap. It could be much worse.
Yeah, so for the most part, I think Pete Richardson has to say, you know, we're going to get the ball to start this second half. We have a chance to get back in the ball game with a touchdown right off the bat.
But really, they have to try and do something to construct an offense that really doesn't rely so much on Terrence Levy, as a guy who was obviously very nervous at the start of the ball game, high on a lot of passes. And, you know, you can look at his face right now and think, you know, that mouth is pretty dry. Yeah, I think I better get another drink before I go out there. So it's going to be up to him to pilot this ball club in the second half.
Well, we know he's capable with his performances the last 2 weeks before this one. But Southern has been a come-from-behind team all season long. They're going to have to do it again. Before that field goal on the turnover, it was a dismal showing offensively for the Jaguars.
I think that's the first half they'd just like to forget about. We talked about
that's
the last two ball games where, you know, they've had comeback wins. They've had big offensive performances. And, you know, this one hasn't started out like a movie that everybody wants to see the first weekend, but it may end up that way for Southern.
Well, Tellis Bolden will kick it off for Hampton. And we get the second half underway at the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. This is Plain cutting back to the 25. Got away from another tackler, a buoy it is, excuse me. And Buoy still on the run to the 32-yard line. Kerry Buoy, a nice return of 20 yards, dancing his way all the way across the field. Tackle made by Dwayne Little.
And I think, guys, when they see Bowie's 5 feet, 6 inches tall, they think, we can just come up and pop him. You saw him get popped. He remained on his feet, that low center of gravity. You don't get knocked off your feet as easily. Did a nice job in weaving a return out of that.
So spot the ball at the Southern 32-yard line on the first possession of the second half. Terrence Levy at quarterback in the shotgun. Handoff on the first play of the second half to Ryan Lewis. And Lewis has about 9 yards before he's tracked down by Deion Hunt. And just based on one play, James, it looks like the Jaguars have a little more spring in their step.
And you watch Deion Hunt, the all-everything, all-American player of the year. And if your defensive line doesn't stop the charge of the offensive line, you won't be very effective as a linebacker.
Second and a yard. Quarterback draw. Levy has the first down and smacked hard about a yard beyond the sticks by Michael Bland and Deion Hunt. Well, when you're down to your backup and very little else, I don't know how many times you keep running that quarterback draw. He took a pounding that time.
That's one of the plays they ran early in the ballgame, that quarterback draw, and Hunt went to the left. Quarterback goes the other way that time. Another good job by Hunt actually reading the play and stopping it this time.
Southern first down. Hand off to Lewis. Breaks to the outside. Bounces across the 45 down to the 42-yard line where Vincent Lewis knocks him out of bounds. Ryan Lewis, just to me, on the two running plays he's had so far in this third quarter, looks to be a little quicker, 13 yards on that one.
Well, Lewis, he's going to go to his right, but he sees that it's clogged up there, peels back to his left, finds a running lane. A little bit of holding right there, but the officials don't call it. But Lewis, good job in seeing that it wasn't there on the right side.
Trying to get his own man, Kenrick Batiste, out of his way. 10 rushes, 40 yards now for Lewis. Two good bursts here to start the second half. Looks like the same play, well, coming the same direction anyway. And Lewis to the outside and bumped out of bounds at the 27-yard line by Lewis. Vincent Lewis knocking out Ryan Lewis. A 15-yard gain.
Remember the Pittsburgh Steelers, and they ran all those trap plays. Watch the lane coming in this direction. You're going to see it. And then you see Damon Nivens right there. He gets Deion Hunt in the middle of it, and Lewis just turns on the speed. He wasn't sure if the hole was going to be there. You saw a little hesitation. But when a guy can fly, hesitation or none, it doesn't bother him.
And finally, a gaping hole open. Here's Lewis, Ryan Lewis, behind blockers to the right side to the 21-yard line, where he's hit by Greg Scott. Lewis had only 18 yards rushing in the first half. On this drive already, he has 43.
I think when you go in the locker room at halftime, the coaches get together and talk about, okay, what worked, what didn't work. What didn't work, we didn't throw the ball very well, but Ryan Lewis, we know what he can do. 1,100 yards for us this season. He's had the bulk of the carries the second half. He's out now. You got to imagine 43 yards. He can run 100 meters and not get tired, though.
He's the 100-meter specialist. Dane Lewis takes his place in the backfield as the pass is complete to Anderson. And the tight end is to the 10-yard line and just beyond. 13-yard gain. First and goal, Southern. Vincent Lewis doing yeoman work in the Hampton backfield, making the tackle of the tight end Anderson.
But a good job of putting plays together back to back. You run the ball, you run the ball, you run. You fake a run, you peel your tight end off underneath. Very safe pass for Levy. You're not asking him to throw downfield into coverage. But that time, all you do, hit the tight end, you get some successful momentum going.
Hampton takes a timeout to try to regroup on defense. Southern is driving.
The McDonald's Heritage Bowl is brought to you by Irish Spring Sport Deodorant Soap, proud sponsor of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. By National Car Rental, so what are you waiting for? Let's go! By Mach 3 from Gillette, the first triple blade razor for the closest shave and fewer strokes with less irritation. And by the United States Marine Corps, the change is forever.
It's 10-3 Hampton early in the third, but Southern is driving. First and goal from the 9. Ryan Lewis back into the game, trying to get the corner. Dragged down from behind at the line of scrimmage by Curtis Blackwell.
You know, we've seen Southern hand the ball to Ryan Lewis, and you know what that is? It's the same girl with a different dress on. You have three wide receivers out wide on the first play. You have three wide receivers here, one up there. You give the ball to Ryan Lewis again. Here you split them out, 2 and 2. You give it to Ryan Lewis. So it's that same girl, but every time she comes to the door asking, do you want to buy cookies, she has on a different dress.
Well, it's been an attractive dress if you're a Southern fan, because they've exceeded their first half total yards on this drive. Play action fake. Levy drills, deflected, intercepted. A one-hand grab. Unbelievable interception. Just the hands of Kaysen. Corey Kaysen took one big mitt, stuck it out, and hung on to the football.
And you start thinking, okay, the first interception, the guy got it. Second, the third. And then by the fourth, when you're wondering, maybe it's not our day. Maybe the other team is good. But you know what? You don't stop playing here. And he's trying to force that ball in. He had Daniel Anderson, his tight end, open. But he didn't look his direction, trying to get the ball to Calvin Mills, his fullback. And you saw him throw it hard. When a guy throws the ball really hard, that means he's throwing it late. So he's trying to fit that ball in late. And a nice interception off the deflection by Corey Kaysen.
Kaysen might want to take a turn at wide receiver based on that one-hand grab. Here's Coley getting a couple of tough yards on first down. Hit by Channing Warner.
Now it's time to see if the pep talk inspired the defense. We saw what it did for the offense of Southern. Got them going, got them motivated. Southern played well defensively for the most part in the first half. They had turnovers. They closed the door a couple of times. Can they keep them pinned down in their own territory right here?
Four interceptions thrown by Terrence Levy today. Quick drop by Johnson, his pass low, but caught by Smith. Smith went down to his knees to get it. It'll be well short of a first down.
And when you're watching that play, you think, why can't he just throw it out there where he's going to catch it? That time, he throws to his back shoulder, which he's supposed to. And you got to think, Roy Johnson's thinking, I don't want to throw an interception here. He doesn't throw a completion. It gets called complete. That ball
skipped
off the turf. But he's trying to keep the ball away from the defensive back. He does a nice job in that because he's thinking, we don't need a turnover here.
Smith's fifth catch of the day, although it didn't look like it was a legal catch. Johnson rolls, got a couple of blocks, turns the corner and keeps, got away from Warner momentarily, but Warner able to nudge him out of bounds at around the 20-yard line. And it will be enough for a Hampton first down. So a good scramble by Roy Johnson, and the Pirates keep their drive alive.
And there you saw Alonzo Lee, the defensive coordinator. It looks like a big mess. But actually, defensive players can read that. They can read all the scripts. And now here comes one guy in just to block our shot. That's his job. But you're drawn up in the middle. And you know what? It gets down and dirty in there. And that looks down and dirty while he's drawn it.
Johnson with a roll. Cuts upfield. And is caught from behind after a gain of 2 or 3 yards by Gillis Wilson. Wilson's had a big game at defensive end for the Jaguars today.
You know, you saw Alonzo Lee there, and he and Joe Taylor, the head coach, go way back. And Joe Taylor said, well, you know, offense is very constructive. We put things together. We try and bring players along. They mature. But defense is constructive. You just get in there, you blow stuff up, you get in people's way, and that's the way that's drawn up. That doesn't make sense to anybody but a defensive player.
Second down play, quick toss. Coley can't spin away. Taken down at the 24-yard line by Bradley Pittman.
He'll give you a Rosalie.
Well, those defensive players are pretty smart, James. In fact, here's before the game, and they're practicing the signals. Alonzo Lee is making sure that his defensive players know those signals. So you're right, they can read that scribbling, and they also can spot the signs from the sideline. I guess what you're saying is defensive players are just a lot smarter.
But you notice all the defensive players learn the signals. So if the main guy gets hit the head, which they do a lot on defense, the other guys can pick it up.
Johnson with a completion while he was headed to the turf for 15 yards and a first down to Coley. Johnson was hit, was falling to the turf and let it go.
And DeMarcus Miller that time lined up at defensive end, just blew right past James McCall. He's on his heels. You see Roy Johnson turning to his left and watch DeMarcus Miller, excuse me, that's number 98, Roshan Matthews, coming in and puts that pressure on him, and just a little flip of his hands gets that ball to Coley. Coley, you know, listed at 5'8", a little bit of a vertical there.
Yep, he showed it to us there as he went upstairs to get it, and another Hampton first down. Here's Coley on the ground, bursting free for a moment into Southern territory. Another first down. He's to the 45-yard line after that 14-yard jaunt.
You know, we talked about Coley being three-time player of the year over in North Carolina, 276 yards a game while he was in high school. You know what he does for a guy who's not real tall? He runs extremely well between the tackles. You would normally think a guy 5'9", all he wants to do is get to the boundary, use his speed, show everybody how fast he is. This guy really does run the ball well in between the tackles.
And the Southern Jaguars call for a timeout. 8:36 left in the third quarter. We're still 10-3, Hampton. And earlier today, we had the Gillette Challenge, and we'll show you the result of that, the Gillette Touchdown Challenge, which took place at halftime here at the Georgia Dome. And on an attempted quarterback draw, Roy Johnson stopped for a loss by Roshan Matthews and DeMarcus Miller. Big loss on the play, and the Southern defense, Gillis Wilson in there also, comes through with a big defensive stop.
You know, think that if you're going to run a quarterback draw, you want the defensive guys to come in their lanes and you want to push them to the outside. You see just a little push there, but when you have DeMarcus Miller in the middle, you're not going to push him around and make him go where he doesn't want to go. And he says he can sense draws. I know where the screens are coming. Don't run the ball at me and try and get some respect.
Boo-boo. High formation on this second and long play. Johnson has good protection, completes it over the middle of Mike Jones, and Jones gets the loss back to the original sticks. It'll be third and 10 coming up. And as we mentioned earlier, Kenneth Murin of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, got an opportunity to throw a football for $25,000 in the Gillette Touchdown Challenge, and he forced it through. So congratulations to Kenneth Murin. He won $12,500 with another $12,500 going to the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation in the Gillette Touchdown Challenge.
Tom, I did a little bit of math, and if he were an NFL quarterback, he completed 300 passes during the year, he'd only be making $3.6 million. He's underpaid at that $12,500 for one completion.
I've seen a lot worse passes than that in the NFL this year. Flag down on the play, and Johnson down as well, dragged down with a loss on the play by Roshan Matthews as the Jaguars have stepped up the defensive pressure the last three downs.
And they stepped it up with just a four-man pass rush.
Illegal shift against the offense, decline, the down counts.
You got two men moving, or you don't get set for a complete count before the ball is snapped and you get that illegal shift called on you.
So decline the penalty and send Bolden out to punt again on fourth down.
10-yard line, Marlon.
And back to receive it is Marcus Alexander. Alexander standing at his own 11-yard line. High snap, and Bolden decides to run with it. Bolden, out of bounds, right at the marker. Let's see. Yes, they'll give him enough forward progress. It will be a Hampton first down. James, was that planned, or did he just see the high snap and take off?
You know, the only plan there was, hey, I think this ball may go over my head. I just want to catch it. But Bolden does a nice job. He talked to Joe Taylor. He said, you know, we have an unusual punt formation in that we split four guys out wide. That time, that's a high snap. He saw the guy coming in. If he tries to take his normal approach and punt that ball probably gets blocked.
So Bolden with a clutch scramble after the high snap. And Hampton has a first down. They're at the 33-yard line of the Jaguars. Coley picking his way, upended at the 30-yard line. A gain of three on the play. Look at Coley, dwarfed by the defenders. Montrell Coley only 5'9 at best. But you questioned that, didn't you, James?
Yeah, but I still say that he runs as well in between the tackles as any 6'2", 225-pound running back, because he makes a commitment when he takes that ball. It's not, oh, I'm picking to see if there's a hole. He takes off toward the line of scrimmage.
He's gained 64 yards on 12 carries so far. Toss it to Coley. Got a block on the corner, but could not get away from Donnie Dillon. Dillon, the Southern linebacker, played it well. He's a senior from McCall Creek, Mississippi.
Hey, look at Hampton, 219 yards per game up here where they're first in the MEAC. You know what that correlates to? This number down here at the bottom, time of possession, 34 minutes, 12 seconds, number one in the MEAC. A good way to play defense is by keeping the other team's offense off the field.
And doing a good job of it on this drive, 6 minutes, 20 seconds, thanks to the scramble from punt formation by Bolden. Play clock is about to expire. Just got it away. Johnson's pass caught at the 20-yard line. Broughton made a nice catch. Broughton came into the game with 31 receptions, tied for number one on the Pirates squad. Edrees Brown, the all-SWAC strong safety, made the tackle. Brown coming off that three-interception game in the SWAC championship.
And that connection right there makes a lot of people in the stands happy, because these two were teammates in high school over in Stone Mountain at Reed Dan High School, and they played the wing team offense. And Johnson was a quarterback, and Broughton was the split end. He said, you know, he didn't throw to me a lot in high school. Maybe he didn't want to make me look good.
The last 2 years, they paid their way in to watch the Heritage Bowl while they were home on school vacation and saw Southern win both those games. Draw play handoff to Hales. Travis Hales to the 15-yard line. Ball control drive by the Hampton Pirates, hoping to add to their 10-3 lead after the interception prevented what looked to be a Southern scoring drive.
And then we talked about that offensive line, and Jason Thomas, the guy going to the Hula Bowl, is actually the little one of the bunch with 305 pounds. And you know what? They're not big and flabby. Joe Taylor said, hey, we get those kids in here, we work them. You won't see any guts hanging over their belt buckles.
Second and four. Weidman, the motion man. Coley. No, it's not Coley. It's Hales again. Hales makes a cut at the five, down to the 3-yard line. The freshman Travis Hales, who has come on late, this is only the seventh game he's played this season. He's from Richmond, Virginia. Gains 11 on that play, but here's a young man that the Hampton coaches like a lot, and they've used him more and more as the season's progressed.
And we talked about this man right here. He's uncovered. When you're uncovered, that means that you're going to be on the move. Watch, you get the double team right there, and watch, just a total blockout. When you turn your man and turn him away from the hole, you give your running back a huge lane to run through. You know what, Tom? I think I'd have gained about 7 going through there. You might have gained 3.
Look at the drive. Lucky to have made the line of scrimmage, I'm sorry to say. Travis Hales came into the game averaging 5 yards a carry. As we said, they're just getting the playing time toward the end of the season. Got the carry there for his 5th of this game, and he's gained 25 yards, so right on his average as he limps off to the field after grabbing his leg. Dillon and Johnson made the stop for Southern.
Now the tough thing here is if you run at DeMarcus Miller, he's tough. If you run away from him, he's so quick that you have to double team him.
Second and goal from the two. Pitch it to Coley. Coley trapped in the backfield and taken down. Boy, the Southern defense was ready for that one. How many times have we seen the Jaguars today in the shadow of their own goal line stiffen up and prevent the touchdown?
They really have. The only time that Southern was able to get in the end zone was on the halfback pass from Coley to Wyden. But here they try and toss the ball. And when you go wide, all the defensive players see it, and they react to it. Guy who does a great job right out there on the edge is Robert Chapman, because he takes up two blockers. But when you take up two blockers, you stretch the play, you give the rest of the team a chance to pursue and get in on the tackle.
This drive has consumed 9.5 minutes, but now Hampton needs to get some points. They are third and goal from the 7. Johnson in the pocket. Flips it out complete. Wyden has his second touchdown. Adrian Wyden with a touchdown catch for the Hampton Pirates.
That play is a byproduct of keeping the defense on the field for almost 10 minutes. You saw Johnson back, he drops back, then he continues to drift back because he knows who my outlet receiver is, and by the time he lets this ball go, all the defensive linemen are just kind of standing around. There's really no hot pursuit of him.
9 minutes and 44 seconds on the drive. The extra point is good, and Hampton with one of the most impressive drives of the day. Taking time off the clock, a key play, Bolden's fourth down run from punt formation, and Hampton has a 17-3 lead.
Mom said to share these. One for you and one for me. Two for you, two for me. Three for you, three for me. Four for you, four for me. Okay, we'll start over.
Here's the big play. The McDonald's Heritage Bowl sweepstakes. Your chance of winning can be as easy as knowing the score. Play and you make touchdown in Jamaica or win other great prizes. Entry forms and details are in these December magazines, but you gotta play to win. Got it? Good.
Tired of waiting in long lines to check in? When you have an assigned seat with an e-ticket from Delta Airlines, you don't have to. Only a Delta e-ticket lets you check in at the curb and go straight onto the plane at 95 airports nationwide. Delta e-ticket, the E makes it easier.
Introducing Colgate Total Fresh Stripe Toothpaste. A fresh minty gel that keeps working long after you've finished brushing. Fighting bad breath while you're out and about. Fighting cavities and tartar when you're center stage. It even fights plaque and gingivitis. For protection all day or all night. Colgate Total Fresh Stripe Toothpaste. The brushing that works between brushings.
The Knicks, the Pacers. Last season, without Patrick Ewing, New York pulled off the amazing playoff upset. Now they meet again. Then the Spurs, the Lakers, the defending champs face hot new look LA. Plus, throughout the night, the 10 greatest moments in NBA history. An NBA on NBC doubleheader, Christmas night, 7 Eastern.
While we're away, the activity on the sidelines pretty much told the story. That's the Southern sideline. Their defense gathering around after surrendering that long drive. And over on the Hampton sideline, Roy Johnson, all smiles. Kickoff returned by Bowie to the 27-yard line. Tackled by Deion Hunt, an 18-yard return. That last drive by Hampton consumed 9 minutes and 44 seconds. It's impressive, but contrast it to Southern's performance, and it's even more
oh,
so.
Yeah.
As Roy Johnson, there's Wyden, who had only one touchdown catch all season, has two in this game. Johnson tosses his 10th touchdown pass of the season, but 9 minutes and 44 seconds on the drive. Southern's total time of possession for the game is only 11:45, two more minutes than that single drive. Ryan Lewis dancing his way across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Good gain on first down before he's caught by Corey Kaysen.
Yeah, but I'm not sure if you can run your way back into the ball game, if you can play action your way back into the ball game. You have to remember who got you here. And the guy that got him here over the last 2 weeks was Michael Hayes. He had caught 22 passes, 373 yards, and three touchdowns. Today it's been a much different story.
Two catches for 10 yards. Hayes nullified by the defense of Hampton. There's another handoff to Ryan Lewis. He has a first down, sprints across the 40 to the 42, where he's taken out of bounds by Vincent Lewis. Lewis over 70 yards rushing on the afternoon now. 75 to be exact on 15 carries.
Look at Terrence Levy, 5 completions, 4 interceptions. The guy who protected the ball very well coming into this ballgame has not done a good job today.
Empty backfield on first down. Quarterback draw by Levy gets a loss of 2. Back to the 40, Greg Scott. And I think they've gone to that play once too often.
And that's going to add an insult to injury. You won't let me throw it, but you're going to make me
or injury
run
to
the
insult.
Injury to insult.
They smacked him down.
And make me run the ball instead of letting me throw the ball. You know? I'm a quarterback. I'm not a running back. I'm not real shifty back here. And, you know, we fooled him a couple times on that draw, but it's not a staple.
Final minute of the third quarter. Levy, good protection here. Lost it downfield. Jump ball.
Incomplete.
Nope. Intercepted again. I thought for a moment he was ruling that it was incomplete, but Mooney came down with it.
Yeah, but he took it away from Vincent Lewis on the ground. We're going to have to get with the official score to see who intercepts this pass, because he tried to throw this ball deep. His receiver kind of doesn't really give up on it, just can't get to it. And there you see the two guys on the ground. Vincent Lewis has it. Rashad Mooney's there. And that's 4 sets of hands there. You know, you can divide up a sack, but you can't divide up an interception. You see guys get half a sack, but can you give them half an interception?
I wasn't sure the ball hadn't hit the turf, but it is ruled an interception. The 5th of the day thrown by Terrence Levy. That's Hales fighting his, or no, it's Compton fighting his way forward after making the reception. 14-yard gain. Well, we said that Cinderella had turned into a pumpkin. Terrence Levy has had a nightmare afternoon. 5 completions and 5 interceptions.
And he's getting on that phone, and there aren't a lot of good conversations that you have after you throw interceptions. You see Eric Dooley, the coach, right out of the picture there. He's not even paying attention to him. It's like, well, this isn't happening to us.
Terrence is such a likable young man. It's a shame to see him suffer through a day like this. Down in the Southern Territory again. It'll be first down Hampton at the 49-yard line. That covered 12 yards, and now Hampton biting off huge chunks of real estate as the Southern defense has to go back on the field again after yet another turnover. And the final seconds of the third quarter ticking away. It looked like Southern had perhaps recaptured the momentum as they drove down the field to start the third quarter, but then another interception has swung the tide back in Hampton's favor. That's the end of the third quarter at the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. It's the Hampton-Southern matchup, and the Hampton Pirates holding the upper hand now. At the end of 3 at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, it's Hampton leading 17-3. We'll be right back after these words from your local station.
Who wants to win $1 million when you can win big money? 21 is coming to NBC.
Critics love Martin Short. The Denver Post says the man is brilliant. Coming on the next Martin Short show, Malcolm and Eddie's Eddie Griffin. Plus, veteran entertainment reporter Jiminy Glick grills actor Thomas Gibson. On the next Martin Short Show, where you never know what'll happen next.
Give me my money!
Hit it!
Monday at 11 on NBC 12.
All righty then.
NBC Tonight at 8, 7 Central. Jim Carrey is Ace Ventura.
Do I have something in my teeth?
Tonight at a special time.
Alrighty then.
Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls. NBC Tonight at 8, 7 Central. Then. Join Billy Crystal, Mary J. Blige, Sting, 98 Degrees, and more. Radio City Music Hall's grand reopening gala, tonight on NBC.
Amazing grace.
This planet we call Earth, a remarkable confluence of time, space, and majesty, which has given life to more than 10 million species. An amazing place of truly amazing grace. We are caretakers for the preservation of this earth. Our mission is to ensure diversity is preserved. For from diversity comes new food, new cures, new life. We are World Wildlife Fund, almost 4 decades old, and more than 1 million members strong. With your help, we can keep this planet in a state of grace. Please call for your free action kit with 10 simple things you can do to help leave our children a living planet.
On your side with NBC 12 News Weekends.
If you're writing a script for Hampton, it doesn't get any better than this. One of the many interceptions, and then the high snap. Tell us, Bolin, you'll pick up the stats and say, he rushed for 12 yards, who's he? And Weidman, another wide open touchdown pass.
And so the Southern Jaguars, with that gaudy 11-1 record, in danger of tasting defeat here at the Heritage Bowl as we open the fourth quarter with Hampton up 17-3. Total plays in the game, Hampton has run 68-38 for Southern.
And one thing happens, you leave your defense on the field this long, and at the beginning of the fourth quarter, you're down by 14. You get a sense of desperation, so you start trying to strip the ball away, which is good. But the defensive backs, they think, well, we need an interception. We need that big play. Out and up fakes get them. You try and step in front of balls, and guys end up going the other way for touchdowns.
Hampton had that long drive before. They'd love to do another one here, a little more ball control. The last one consumed nearly 10 minutes. And they will keep it on the ground to Coley, and he stopped for a loss back at midfield. Good penetration by Nathaniel Bell and Gillis Wilson, two defensive ends who met right at Montrell Coley.
And very tempting for Roy Johnson. We know he has a green light. He can see the blitz. He knows that the defensive pressure is going to come. He knows it's a running play. Just hand the ball off. Eat that clock up, because the clock really is the most important thing. But you don't want to get so conservative that you think, well, we got this game won, because you don't have the game won. You've watched Southern the last 2 weeks. They've been behind. What have they done? They've come back. They've found ways to win. That's why they're 11-1.
Milking the play clock right down to the final second, and then the pass batted right back in the face of Roy Johnson by Nathaniel Bell. That's his second deflection of the day. We mentioned he was 6'6", with a pretty good wingspan, and he can get a hand on that ball easily.
Now, if I'm Southern right here, and I know that Hampton likes to use that spread punt formation, I've seen a low snap, I've seen a high snap. Now is the time I come off that edge, off that inside guy, and come after the punter. Right here, come after those guys. They don't do it.
High snap, too.
High snap.
They could have perhaps been in position to block it. Alexander calls for a fair catch and makes it at around the 20-yard line. It'll be Southern's ball when we return to the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Hampton in the lead.
How about some puzzles?
Puzzles, huh?
Maybe I'll have a bike. Some CDs. A lizard.
A lizard?
Or some clothes. Or maybe the earrings.
Uh-huh.
Mom, she still doesn't know what she wants.
Need a little rescuing? Get to McDonald's for toy candy dispensers like Buzz and Woody, based on characters from Disney and Pixar's new movie Toy Story 2. Collect all six. They're only $1.99 each when you buy a large sandwich or meal combination. Now, where do you get the sweetest toys this season? Did somebody say McDonald's?
Come on, come on, come on, come on, what you wear?
I be kicking that belly, belly, man.
Hey, what you wear?
You wearing that Barbie Kelly, man.
What you wear?
I be kicking that belly, belly, man.
Hey, what you wear?
I be kicking that belly, belly, man.
Bring it on now.
Reporting live from hell, I should say. People are going hella crazy due to the sellout. Magazines, coats, shirts, sportswear. People are going hella crazy.
We'll be right back.
The 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl is brought to you by McDonald's and its franchisees. Once again, proud to sponsor the 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl. By Pele Pele, the original urban brand of choice since 1978. By Tampax, Tampax was there. And by Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Well, on October 2nd, Hampton, then the Sheridan Poll's number one black college team, met Southern in Indianapolis. Jaguar fullback Lee Smith's two-yard TD run gave his team a 7-3 lead. Southern's defense dominated. Seven sacks, two interceptions, and a 35-yard fumble return for a touchdown by linebacker Robert Chapman as Southern beat Hampton 21-6. It's been a different story here today, though, in the Heritage Bowl. Hampton in control 17-3 as Southern takes over. First down at their own 19-yard line. We're in the fourth quarter, 13:22 on the clock. Ryan Lewis has the speed to go on a big play, but that one finally stopped after a gain of 16 at the 35-yard line by Travis Coleman. Lewis broke off a big one last week against Jackson State in the SWAC championship game.
And this has obviously been their best play in the second half. But, you know, I was watching that flashback. You know what the difference is for Southern? They had those yellow pants on. They need to go back in the locker room, find the yellow pants.
Too late now, James. From the gun, Levy fumbled, got the bounce right back to him. Now he cuts up, loses the football, scramble for it, still loose. And Hampton has it at the 40-yard line. The sixth turnover of the day. Deion Hunt, right in the middle of things as always. The sixth turnover by Southern. And unfortunately for Terrence Levy, after the five interceptions, the fumble is his as well.
Yeah, and you know, you fumble the snap from center, then you get in traffic. You don't put the ball away, and it gets that pressure from behind. Deion Hunt comes in there. Then the ball, and you know, it's one of those days. Goes past two of your players, and then finally Spate from Hampton just gets on it. Another turnover. Levy is just having a frustrating day. You know, he's been at the hand of all six turnovers.
The injured Jaguar player is Lonnie Clayton, a senior offensive lineman. And while they tend to Clayton, we'll take a break.
Come to McDonald.
Lonnie Clayton, the injured Southern player.
And you think about football and all the head-on collisions. Well, players normally get hurt doing something that they're not used to, and Clayton trying to reach out and grab this interception, you know, fumble rather, and just gets pounced on from behind. And, you know, big linemen, they don't get jumped on. Their backs don't get jumped on. They normally jump on other people's back.
With producer Ed Fibishoff, director Kelly Atkinson, Tom Hammond, James Lofton, Ahmad Rashad at the McDonald's Heritage Bowl in Atlanta. Fourth quarter, and Hampton now, after the turnover, perhaps driving to put the game away. And it is Hales who gets the call again, or Jones, excuse me, Jones 36. Pretty good collision over at the sideline as Sean Overton came up to hit him.
And you know what that is? Classic fullback getting a chance to run the football. Jones, during the course of the season, rushed for over 600 yards. But, you know, tailbacks, they try and make people miss. Fullbacks, no. They look for people. They say, okay, you got on the other jersey? Here I come.
Hampton trying to use as much clock as they can. And the veteran quarterback, Roy Johnson, milking the play clock and keeping it on the ground. And that will be an easy first down for Hampton as Mike Jones tugs the football close to the 25-yard line. Gillis Wilson, DeMarcus Miller, Cantrell Blatcher.
And check out these names.
Right. Some MEAC Hall of Famers.
Deacon Jones, I remember him. I grew up in Los Angeles. And Art Shell, coach with the Raiders while I was there. Larry Little has also coached in the MEAC. And Willie Lanier, the all-pro linebacker from the Kansas City Chiefs.
Art Shell, one of the all-time best offensive linemen in the NFL. First down play. Coley bouncing to the outside, hauled down by Channing Warner and Donnie Dillon. Dillon, the man that grabbed him on the pads and took him down. Chapman was there too. And the SWAC members of the Pro Football Hall of Fame, a pretty gaudy list as well.
Yeah, four guys from Grambling, a couple from Jackson State. We see Walter Payton down there, and maybe the greatest football player, and Deacon Jones makes the list on both
sides. That's right. I was going to see if you caught that, James. Ledger.
Oh, yeah. I got my speed reading course in.
And the great Walter Payton, as you said.
I didn't mention Mel Blount because, you know, I never got open against
him. Wow. A tough DB he was. Johnson. Second down pass. And it's complete. Catch made by Broughton on the sideline. Johnson applauds another completion.
We talked about Johnson in the NFL, and one of the measures of a quarterback, you take that five-step drop back, seven steps. Can you throw that deep sideline ball? And there it is right there, right on the sideline. And, you know, up front, you need protection. You don't want guys coming in on you. And there's the left tackle, Mitchell Foreman, all-MEAC performer, going up against Gillis Wilson, all SWAC. And I call that one a draw. And a draw is good for the offense when you're talking about your quarterback not taking the pounding.
Tie goes to the offense. 17-3 game. Hampton bidding to upset the 11-1 Southern Jaguars. Their coach Joe Taylor had a month or so to prepare his team. They've been ready.
Please reset to 10:42. The play was out of bounds.
We'll adjust the clock here. The sad story for Southern and Pete Richardson today has been 10 possessions total in the game. Six turnovers. Pretty tough to win a football game that way.
More turnovers than points.
And Pete let his feelings be known about having to play the third place team from the MEAC. Not pleased with it. And his team not sharp today. Third down play, third and inches. And another first down carry by Mike Jones. Well, Pete Richardson certainly has proven his credentials over the years at Southern. One of the best coaches in all of 1AA, if not all of football. And I asked him yesterday about not being interviewed for some of the major football jobs that have come open, including across town at Baton Rouge, the LSU job just filled.
And we talked about it. He said the phone didn't ring. Not even one time. I said, were you kind of waiting on it? He said, well, I looked at it, and I hope that it might ring.
First and goal for Hampton, and as the play clock ticks down, they call a timeout. So Hampton takes a timeout with 10:13 left in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Turns starting at 7 Eastern, a rematch of last year's Eastern Conference Finals. The Knicks face the Pacers. Then in the nightcap, it'll be the defending champion, world champion San Antonio Spurs against Shaq and the Lakers. That's an NBA holiday doubleheader, Christmas Day, starting at 7 o'clock Eastern, only on NBC.
See, now basketball has it about right. They have the East and the West geographically, you know, worked out pretty well. You look at the NFL and it's,
oh, yeah,
it's a sad case.
Time of possession pretty much tells the story. Draw play, Coley carrying tacklers to the 3-yard line. Shannon Smith hopped on his back, couldn't get him down until he had reached the three. As the Southern Jaguars, carrying the holiday spirit of giving to extremes today, have turned the ball over 6 times and are in danger of losing for only the second time this season.
And the defense is just at the point now where they're basically exhausted. They've been out on the field much longer than they need to have been. And offensively, you're able to throw in a fresh running back, another fullback, a guy here, but defensively, keep the same 11 guys out there.
Second and goal, flag down as Coley cuts for the end zone and comes up just short. Taken down by Channing Warner, who is playing his final game for Southern. Their leading tackler the last 2 years.
You got that illegal shift or illegal movement. You had the receiver in motion, the back not set.
Illegal shift against the offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
He hadn't had a lot to be upset about today. You had a couple misfires early, that 4th-and-1 where you fumble the snap from the center. His field goal kicker, A.C. Wyatt, was wide right on the field goal. But for the most part, they played a very efficient game, you talk about. Wanted to be constructive. He really has put things together piece by piece by piece in this ball game.
Coach Taylor's going to be telling some pretty good tales when he starts having his Friday fish fries again in the offseason. There's a toss for the end zone. No good, out of bounds. Catch made by Smith, but he couldn't keep one foot into the end zone. Covered by Hill.
You know what, Smith, the one thing you have to do as a wire, you have to save that outside room. He's running right along the boundary. There's not a lot of space for him to complete that ball. And when you get by that guy, you have to squeeze a little bit. Makes a nice catch, but you know, you got to catch it in the purple stuff.
Purple stuff is always good. It's third and goal. Johnson with the quarterback draw. And taken down by the ankles by Channing Warner. Warner would have had none of it. And it'll be fourth down for Hampton.
And the job of the middle linebacker, you drop back into coverage, then you're looking right at the quarterback because he was going to throw the ball, and he uses the official as a screen. He won't let Jason Thomas, number 65, come out and block him. Run around the official. That's kind of like when you're a kid, you know, you run around a car to get open. You're playing touch football in the street.
Wyatt will attempt a 25-yard field goal. And the kick is no good. Wyatt right again. So Wyatt's second miss of the day. He did hit one. But as James said, not too much has gone wrong for Hampton today. With 8 minutes and 24 seconds left in the Heritage Bowl, Hampton in control, 17-3 over Southern.
What?
The new 2000 Ford Focus can handle anything you can dream up.
Is there an underdog in you? Is there a stubborn fool in you? Is there a screaming child in you? Is there a crazed lunatic in you?
You've got the road refs.
Caller, why don't you kick it off?
Hey, guys. I didn't make the travel squad, but I still want to follow the team.
Not to worry, sport. Even if you can't catch a cold, you can always catch a Greyhound.
Good call, Trek. With Greyhound's everyday low fares and no advance purchase, you could go all the way.
I got the old school spirit. Give me a G.
Go Greyhound and leave the driving to us.
Oh, man. I think the backboard just shattered.
All righty then.
NBC tonight at 8, 7 Central. Jim Carrey is Ace Ventura.
Do I have something in my teeth?
Tonight at a special time.
All righty then.
Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls. NBC tonight at 8, 7 Central.
We talked about Terrence Levy last week, the fantastic ball game in the SWAC Championship. 426 yards today. It has been turnover after turnover after turnover. You know, you would think when this ball game started, he said, if I could just do half of what I did in the previous weeks, we'll be okay. But try as he might, nothing has gone right for Terrence Levy so far.
And if you're wondering about perhaps taking Levy out, very little choice for Pete Richardson. The backup is Quincy Richard, a freshman who was scheduled to be redshirted this season. But in the Bayou Classic, after Troy Williams had dislocated his hip, Levy came on, and Levy suffered a cut on the chin that forced him to leave the game. And Richard had to go in for a couple of snaps, ruining his redshirt year. So Pete Richardson does not have a whole lot of choice. Very inexperienced freshman Quincy Richard is the Levy backup. Ryan Lewis on that carry, tackled by Damon Dawson. There's Richard and Troy Williams, the injured starter most of the season for Southern. Ryan Lewis, by the way, is approaching 100 yards rushing, 17 carries, 92 yards.
game now.
The wheels have just come off for Richardson and the Jaguars.
The play of game against the offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Quincy Richard, the backup quarterback, does not have his helmet even close, and so I guess Pete Richardson, you see Richard there holding his headgear, so his entrance in the game is not imminent.
You talked about the wheels coming off. I think the air conditioning is broken and the radio doesn't work.
Levy hit as he tried to pass. It'll be ruled charitably an incomplete pass.
You know what? If I'm the backup quarterback, I go find my helmet.
No, I don't know. After watching the Hampton defense, you might want to lose it permanently.
And this is close. The ruling here is if the arm starts forward, even if the ball does go backward, it's called an incomplete pass. And there we see the arm starting forward. The ball goes kind of backward sideways. But you know what? Damon Nivens thinks, am I supposed to block that guy? No, I'll let Ryan Lewis block him. Ryan Lewis is built for blocking. No, he's not.
Third and long for the Jaguars. Levy threw it. I don't know where. Behind, I think, Guyen, who was closest to it. And I don't want to be redundant, but when we talked to Terrence, he was a delightful young man, and it's just a shame to see him have this kind of game on national television. Southern fans were talking about a battle in the spring between Troy Williams and Terrence Levy for the number one job.
And you know what? He still is a delightful young man. And he'll get over this. He'll grow from it. He realized that, you know, he was the backup quarterback. He came in, had a Cinderella game and a half, and it's kind of turned sour. He said that, you know, he's on campus and girls were talking to him for the first time. Well, you know, after Christmas, hopefully they'll be
When I add to the misery, one man to beat,
wow,
and knocked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Coleman nearly took it all the way back, as it was a 48-yard return after the punt by Bussart had covered 42. Coleman with a 48-yard punt run back and nearly got it to the end zone, stopped at the 9-yard line.
And you talk about a fatigue team. You see guys sticking out their arm to make tackles. When you're fresh and the game is going well, you don't stick your arm out. You stick your shoulder in there. You make big hits. You pop people. A lot of arm tackling. And that's fatigue. And part of it, you know, we talked about Hampton having been off the last 3 weeks. Well, Southern has had to work to get here and work hard to get here.
Work hard to come from behind victories against Grambling and Jackson State. Mike Jones, a couple of tough yards to the 7. Channing Warner still in there fighting for the Southern Jaguars. Here's Warner, final game in a Jaguar uniform. All SWAC conference. And Mr. GQ of the Southern team sets the trend in his dress and his behavior. Plans to go to law school eventually, does Channing Warner. Play action fake and a roll by Johnson. He's going to try to duck out of bounds right about the 4-yard line. He wanted end zone, but not badly enough to lower his head.
You know what? that is smart quarterback. You know, there's no reason to take a pounding there. You get out of bounds, you get safe. And, you know, they're running this little, like, loop pattern. The tight end goes out, then he loops up the field, get the wide receiver there, but Overton does a nice job locating him, picking him up, and so you just smartly, very, very smartly, we talked about this guy already having graduated, working on his master's in education. Well, we saw how much of an education he's received over the last 4 years. You get out of bounds and don't get hit.
Third and goal. Jones spinning his way to the 1-yard line. It'll be fourth and goal coming up. Clock down to 6:20 and counting.
You know, and here you think, okay, Joe Taylor, I kick a field goal. That puts me up by 17 points. They can still get back and win the ball game with 3 scores if they go for 2-on-1. But you get a touchdown and you really basically seal the deal here, because, I mean, Southern has not shown any offensive spark. Even if you don't get in the end zone, you turn it over here, they still have to go 99 yards to get near the goal line.
Fourth and goal. Touchdown. But the fumble will not count. He broke the plane of the goal line. Mike Jones with the Hampton touchdown.
And you normally don't see kids, you know, demonstrate too much. And you get this ball, you get real close to the goal line, he's in, ball squirts out, and you see Mike Jones kind of look for it for a second. He goes, no,
touchdown.
Touchdown.
Yeah.
I made a touchdown.
Mike Jones, who ran for 5 touchdowns during the regular season, as his 6th of the campaign. And the extra point is through the uprights, and Hampton has added to its lead. 5:42 left in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. Mike Jones, the senior from Fort Washington, Maryland, breaks the plane of the goal line. Ball comes out. Touchdown, Hampton.
Mom said to share these. One for you and one for me. 2 for you, 2 for me. 3 for you, 3 for me. 4 for you, 4 for me. Okay, we'll start over.
Here's the big play. The McDonald's Heritage Bowl sweepstakes. Your chance at winning can be as easy as knowing the score. Play and you make touchdown in Jamaica or win other great prizes. Entry forms and details are in these December magazines, but you gotta play to win. Got it? Good.
Hi, I'm Bob Vila. You know, your home is your sanctuary, the one place you and your children should feel safe. But there can be dangers, too, and some of them are not so obvious. Improperly wired outlets that can electrocute, water coolers that can burn, household cleaners that can kill, lead paint that can poison. To find out about them, call HUD.
For a free brochure on HUD's healthy homes and FHA loans, just call. HUD and FHA are on your side.
If you're looking for a family adventure, National Car Rental knows the best place to go is the Walt Disney World Resort. You see, National gets you to all the exciting new rides and attractions fast for a magical adventure your family will never forget. So, what are you waiting for? Let's go with National Car Rental, the official car rental company of the Walt Disney World Resort. Let's go.
NBC returns Christmas night.
24-3 Hampton, fourth quarter of the McDonald's Heritage Bowl at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. You know, James, despite the dominance by Hampton today, this is a matchup between two of the most successful black college football teams in recent years. And just talking to the coaches and the players, this is a nice way for many of them to end their career or to get some national TV exposure. The Heritage Bowl concept has been a good idea for everybody.
Yeah, I really believe that it has. And Joe Taylor has done a fine job in getting his team ready with the, you know, 3-week layoff. But for Pete Richardson, it's pretty interesting because what they do at the beginning of the season is they actually pencil this game in as part of their regular schedule.
That's right.
And I talked
Might
to him,
as well,
I said,
five
how
in
do
a
you
row.
Do that? He says it gives the players something to really look forward to. They have great rings from this ball game, the championships that they've won. But you really think about this, the MEAC has to be happy. The teams that are at home watching their Hampton University team come through for them, because it pits conference against conference. And a lot of these kids know each other from high school and other areas. And, you know, we talked to Roy Johnson, the quarterback. He says, you know, whenever I'm playing, I try and say hi to the other guys from Atlanta. And it's a lot easier to say hi after the ball game if you've won.
It's been a nice homecoming for the several Hampton players from the Atlanta area. And to be honest, Southern just looked emotionally spent today. As you mentioned, those two tough wins, both in come-from-behind fashion, in the Bayou Classic against Grambling, and then last week in Birmingham in the first SWAC championship game. So they just didn't have much in the tank today, it didn't appear. And ready for the kickoff by Bolden. by Bowie. Across the 30 to the 40 and hammered at the 45-yard line. Nice return, though, by Kerry Bowie. Covered 38 yards. Anthony Henderson really hit Bowie hard after that nice return.
You would think a guy 5'6 would have a little fear in him, but straight up the field, no fear. And man, he gets crunched.
You could hear it.
5'6, 149. You would expect him to be out at halftime in the band, but he's out there running with the Suicide Squad.
First down for Southern. And very little offense today, mostly turnovers, and they're pretty well summing up. And I think Pete Richardson pretty much concedes the game, having gone almost strictly to the ground here in recent plays. And considering the number of interceptions they've thrown, why not?
Yeah, but I really believe that you get that ball out near midcourt, midfield, you try and go for the end zone. You don't play passing.
You know, I don't know if you want to break the spirit of Terrence Levy or not. Here he wings one wide open down the middle, and a one-handed grab made.
Now, that's good for the spirit of Terrence Levy. Al Joubert, you know, hadn't had much action today, and sometimes you hadn't caught the ball. Your hands get a little rusty. They don't react. Joubert, when they came out for pregame warmups, he trotted by the Hampton defensive backs and, you know, said hello to them. And, you know, he's the smallest of all the receivers, but the smallest guys sometimes have the biggest fight in them, and a great one-handed catch. But what he does after the catch, keeps his balance. This game is not over, I guess.
45-yard strike, Levy to Joubert. Now Levy sacked back at the 21-yard line. Damon Dawson.
Levy's got to realize that when you have a quick three-step drop, takes it in the gun, boom, he's going to get rid of the ball. Get rid of it. That's what the offensive lineman expected you to do. They expect that ball to come out on the correct timing. They know what the pass pattern is called.
Now it's second down and 16 from the 20-yard line. Levy for the end zone. And overshooting Ingrams. Levy on that one play to Joubert covered 45 yards, which exceeded his total in the first 55 minutes of play.
Yeah, we get a little bumping down the field because you look at Spate.
Yep.
His back is to the ball. What he does, he just walls off Ingram. Dan Marino throws this ball. He actually throws it at the back edge of the wide receiver to his backside. The wide receiver turns for the ball.
Looked like an uncatchable ball anyway.
Sure, because the guy knocked him out of the way.
Levy throws another one out of the end zone and incomplete.
Down by 21 on fourth down. I don't think you have an option to kick the field goal right here.
It'll be fourth down and 16 for Levy and the Jaguars.
Hampton has done a real nice job in taking Michael Hayes away from Levy as a receiver. He hasn't even looked in his direction so far.
Hayes,
he has him one-on-one right here, though.
He'd been sensational the last two games. He's been a non-factor today. Levy's pass, again, not catchable. In Hayes' direction, he had double coverage. Ball sailed over his head, and on fourth down, Southern will turn it over.
He's late getting that ball out. If he gets it to him off the break, if he anticipates, they have a chance on that play.
Well, Pete Richardson has said most of the season his offense has struggled. They've struggled big time today. But with a lot of young players, maybe it'll be rosy for them the next couple of years. We'll take a timeout. Hampton University of Virginia making its first appearance in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl as the big lead on Southern, as the Jaguars made their sixth trip to the Heritage Bowl with a 4-1 record before today. There'll be a lot of celebrating on the trip back to Virginia for the Pirates. Hampton just moved from Division II to Division I AA in 1994. They've had fabulous success under their coach Joe Taylor. He's in his eighth season overall, a man that demands a lot of discipline. They dress in a coat and tie and all gather for dinner when they're on the road. Very poised and polished bunch of college students and student athletes. The 7-4 record wasn't as good as the standard they set the past couple of years,
including that 21-6 loss to Southern, their first setback of the campaign. But they made up for it big time with this dominating victory in the Heritage Bowl over Southern, avenging that earlier loss to the Jaguars. As we said, in the offseason, Taylor brings all his friends over for a fish fry at his house every Friday. There's going to be a lot of tales being told with those fish fries on Fridays in this offseason, as they were superbly prepared for this game. And right off the opening kickoff, looked good and have dominated a very good team. Make no mistake about it, Southern is right at the top of 1AA teams. Perennially they are, and again this year. And of course, amongst the historically black colleges, they are always one of the top programs.
And only Florida loss. A&M with that one loss. And
right.
I talked to both coaches and said, what does Florida A&M do so well? I said, they just throw the ball. They get all the receivers down there, and those guys can just flat out run. We can't cover them. They have so many players.
Both Florida A&M and North Carolina A&T from the MEAC had some success in the 1AA playoffs this year before finally being eliminated. And Hampton finishing third behind those two, coming to the Heritage Bowl and pulling off a win too. So it has been a big season for the MEAC. Southwestern Athletic Conference, of course, undergoing some change too, having their first ever championship game in Birmingham last weekend.
You know, I think this must be especially gratifying for Hampton, because I think they came down here with a little trepidation. They had lost to Southern during the course of the regular season. And then after they lost that ball game to Southern, then they lost three out of the next six ball games. So they kind of stumbled in here, but they've righted themselves back up and really put together a fine performance today.
And you have to feel good for their fifth-year senior quarterback, Roy Johnson. He's been a starter since his freshman season. And Coach Joe Taylor telling us yesterday, as Hales runs for 19 yards, Coach Joe Taylor telling us all their success in the last 4 years are due to that man, Roy Johnson. We mentioned earlier, has the green light to change the play at any time. The only player in Joe Taylor's career, which covers 17 years, has had that luxury. He's Johnson, the first player that Taylor has anointed with the ability to change the play at any time in any situation. And the young man Taylor Johnson, who is working on that master's degree in education, wants to coach and teach history if the professional career doesn't pan out, and already has a degree in business management. He said at one time he wanted to be an entrepreneur before he decided that teaching history and coaching football was in his future.
And you know, I think that is a credit to Joe Taylor, the influence that he's had on this young man. You know, we talked about history, and when we talked to him, I asked him, I said, if you could go back in time, and you talked about the civil rights there, he said, I'd want to go back there. I'd want to kind of see the fear,
right?
Not really feel it, but see it, and see what happened during the demonstrations. And but you know, today he's a kid who has shown no fear, especially after that first ball game. He really recovered well and has really turned this situation around for Hampton today.
And what a way to close your another long run. Close your career for Kelly McClendon, the starting center, who has a wife, Anika, and a young four-month-old son, Kelly Jr., who made it to the game today. Won't remember it, but his dad can say, yep, you were there. You saw it the day we won the Heritage Bowl. That was a 16-yard run.
And you mentioned Kelly McClendon, a guy who, you know, has the body of an NFL player, but also has a degree in accounting coming up, and says, you know, I've already started interviewing, because the NFL is not a guarantee, but people will need their taxes and their bookkeeping done.
Don't forget, coming up next, 1994 Olympic gold medalist Tommy Moe leads the Americans. They take to the mountain to compete in the Ford Downhill Series. That's the Ford Downhill Series next on NBC. While we have a moment, thanks to our teammates in the booth, our spotters, Jerry Miller and Marlon Reed, and Dave Clancy on stats, for giving us good service here at the Heritage Bowl. The celebration has started over on the Hampton sideline. The Pirates took the opening kickoff, marched all the way down the field, failed on fourth and inches as the snap was fumbled. But the mistakes by Hampton have been few and far between today. Coach Taylor already accepting congratulations. And obviously this team was ready to play after the layoff, and the time to prepare for Southern, a luxury the Jaguars did not enjoy.
7 seconds showing on the clock. And Atavius Cash, the backup quarterback to Roy Johnson, is into the game. And from the Hampton fans gathered over on the Pirates sideline, great round of applause for Roy Johnson as he comes out of the game in a Hampton uniform for the final time. One kneel down, we'll do it. Hampton University in its first appearance in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl takes home the trophy with a dominating performance against the Southern Jaguars today. Joe Taylor, who has claimed a couple of black college national championships, with great respect for his coaching adversary, Pete Richardson. The two go way back, as we mentioned earlier, in their coaching careers. He knows that to beat Southern is a great accomplishment indeed. And time to take a look at our players of the game as McDonald's and its franchises recognize the 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl players of the game. Vincent Lewis with 3 interceptions. Might have had 4 at his teammate not taking one away from him. He's the Hampton player of the game. And for Southern, Ryan Lewis, who amassed 87 yards on 18 rushes. There's Ryan playing his final game for the Jaguars today. So Hampton wins the McDonald's Heritage Bowl 24-3 over Southern. We'll return to the Georgia Dome for more post-game activities right after these messages. Is underway at the McDonald's Heritage Bowl. The Hampton University Pirates with a victory over Southern in their first appearance at the Heritage Bowl, fueled in part by the Southern miscues, 6 turnovers helping Hampton to their victory today. Right now, let's go down on the field to James Lofton. James?
Guys, I'm down here with Roy Johnson. We got trophy presentation about to happen. We got some of the Hampton Pirates dancing up and down a little bit. Roy, this must feel good. You told us that last year you actually had to pay to get in the ball game and watch as a spectator. You had a better view this year, didn't you?
Yeah, most definitely. We just came out here and tried our best. We knew that we was a better team than the way we played the first time we played them, and we did well. We clicked as a team. Everything worked out, and I'm so proud that we won.
Now, you must have told your offensive lineman something special coming into the ball game. Got sacked 7 times back in October. Today, if you've been playing on grass, you'd have a clean jersey.
Well, I think they did it on their own. I didn't have to tell them anything. They knew that they had something to prove, and I think they did a great job of doing that.
Now, when you think about your 5 years here at Hampton, is this the way that you wanted to go out?
Most definitely. You always want to go out a winner, and we're winners. We're on top.
Now, you talked about the fact that you also had bought 49 tickets for today's ball game. Now, who's up in the stands watching? Who is up there today?
Oh, my mom, my dad, my sister, all my relatives, my families and friends. I just want to say hello to everybody. Nick's Barbershop, Stone Mount, Redan High School. Hey, we're number one right now.
Now, you going back to Hampton, or are you going to stay home the rest of the Christmas break?
I'm staying home and enjoying Christmas break.
Okay. Ahmad, back to you. Back to Tom.
Yeah, back to Tom. As Roy with his 49 tickets for the game. His mom amassed 49 tickets. He had the largest cheering section of anybody here at the Georgia Dome today, and his performance was equal to the honor that his friends and family paid him before and after this game.
How you doing?
Well, you know the final score now, and you and 3 friends may touch down at the Renaissance Jamaica Grand Resort in Ocho Rios. Send each team's halftime or final score on a 3x5 card to the address on your screen by January 6th. Rules and entry forms are in December issues of Ebony, Essence, and BET Weekend. That's the McDonald's Heritage Bowl sweepstakes. And right now, James Lofton back on the field with another interview. Who
Talk
you have this time,
Talk about a guy
James?
Who's understated. Coach Taylor, you pretty calm on the sidelines today. What was it that you felt so comfortable about coming into this ball game?
Well, we had our health back. You know, as I said earlier,
We had 10 straight games without a bye. And when that happens, you know, your guys are pretty beat up. But we took some time off. We got rested. We got healthy. And when we are healthy, you know, we have a good football team. I mean, you don't come into this year with seven championships without doing something right. And that's talent, that's coaching. And we just felt that since we were healthy that we really had a legitimate chance. But nothing to take away from Coach Richardson. Does a real fine job. A lot of respect for him, but our guys just played well. I'm just very, very proud of them.
Now, Roy Johnson playing in this final ball game. When you talked about him yesterday, it was almost like you were talking about somebody who was an extended part of your family. Can you express what his performance today and over the last 5 years has meant to you?
Well, again, this program has really traveled, really moved up, made a lot of progress, and Roy is right in the middle of all of that. You know, he's been a trigger guy. You know, he's made some great checks for us, and believe me, he's a guy, and once he settled down today, he was a little bit hyper, being here at home in front of so many family and friends, made a few early mistakes, but that was just a matter of getting more and more into the ball game. We're going to miss him sorely. We're going to miss him.
Now, you got another pipeline, a couple guys in from Detroit led by Deion Hunt called the Hit Squad. Tell us about them and your relationship with the coach there.
Well, his coach is here today, and, we go back over the years, and certainly he has a strong program in Detroit. James Reynolds.
James Reynolds.
Yes. Real strong program in Detroit. And certainly we're going to keep going there because when winners come from a winning program, they know what it takes to keep winning. So we'll keep that relationship going.
Now, obviously, you guys have established a nice tradition here, but you also have another tradition, your Friday fish fries. You going to be ready for those during the offseason?
Next Friday.
Okay, Tom, the fish fry is on for next Friday. We should be there.
I want to be there too, James. I'll tell you what, he was describing it to us yesterday, and it sounded delicious. He does most of the cooking. They have the hush puppies, the fish prepared in several different ways, and as we said, there's going to be a lot of stories, some of them even true, told at the fish fries. Well, the Hit Squad from Martin Luther King High School in Detroit playing a big part in today's win by Hampton. There's a look at the men. That Hit Squad name dates back to their high school days when their motto was to find somebody and hit them. That carried over to their college days, and led by Deion Hunt, their all-star linebacker. The Hit Squad was a big factor in today's Hampton win in the Heritage Bowl over Southern University. Final count 24-3. We'll hear from New York in our update studio when we return in just a moment.
How about some
the stadium here? The presentations were underway a few moments ago. Vincent Lewis of Hampton winning the Walter Payton MVP trophy, and Walter's brother handing out the trophy, Eddie, just to the right of your screen there, and then the championship trophy for the Heritage Bowl being presented to Coach Joe Taylor of Hampton University. Vincent Lewis, the sophomore safety from Moorhaven, Florida, who had three interceptions, the MVP, and the Hampton University Pirates celebrate a victory in their first appearance in the McDonald's Heritage Bowl with that dominant 24-3 victory over the Southern Jaguars. Once again, that's the final score, Hampton 24 and Southern 3. Coming up next, stay tuned as 1994 Olympic gold medalist Tommy Moe leads the Americans as they take to the mountain to compete in the Ford Downhill Skiing Series. The Hampton Pirates, the dominant team today as they beat the Southern Jaguars and hand the Jags only their second loss of the season. So for James Lofton and Ahmad Rashad, this is Tom Hammond saying so long from the 1999 McDonald's Heritage Bowl.